A local presentation of Delaware County Broadcasting, KMCH Radio, Manchester, Iowa.
West Delaware football is on the air from beautiful and historic Brown Field in Manchester, Iowa. It's the West Delaware Hawks and the Independence Mustangs. Good evening, everybody. Along with my partners Aaron Plain and Bill Logan, this is Jamie Vasky reporting. Aaron, this is a game everybody's been talking about for several weeks now. The hype is over. Brown Field is packed. I mean, Swish and I mentioned in the pregame that hopefully the fire marshal turns the other way. We hope that. We're ready for this top 10 matchup in week number 8.
It doesn't get better than this, Jamie. You got two teams coming in playing extremely good football, both 7-0, as you mentioned, both rivals off Highway 20, about 20, 25 miles apart, and both teams looking to take the district title essentially tonight. So hopefully the Hawks can come in tonight, play good, sound football, and I think if they do that, you know, things will look good for the West Delaware Hawks.
Hawks come in 7-0, 4-0 in Class 3, District number 3, as they won 61-13 in a non-district matchup last week in DeWitt. They moved to 8-0, looking to move 8-0 for the first time since the 2005 season. West Delaware now been to the playoffs 21 times in the state title in 1991, 8 straight playoff appearances, and they have a record of 25-19 in those playoff appearances. 4 sophomores, 16 juniors, and 22 seniors comprise the Hawks 42-player roster. It is senior night here tonight, as all the seniors being announced here. We will do the same later. Head coach Doug Winkowicz, in his 21st year as a head coach, 134-73. His 12th season here at West Delaware, he has a 95-31 record. Has led the Hawks to 9 playoff appearances with that runner-up finish in 2005. Spent 9 years at Garner Hayfield before coming to West Delaware. He's a graduate of Allison High School and Westmar College in Des Moines. His assistant coaches are Corey Coates, Luke Imsland, Brad Rubina, Ryan King, Matt Utoff, Nate Lahr, Mark Becker, Bob Morris, and John Warden. And down on that West Delaware sideline is the third member of our broadcast team, Bill Logan. And Bill, an exciting atmosphere here tonight inside Brown Field, the standing room only at this point.
Yeah, this is what we expected probably since last October. You know, everybody looking for the rematch here. The Hawks want to get back on the winning side of that. Independence coming out, got a great team this year. They fully expected to be undefeated coming into this game tonight, and played out that way. And, man, this is a huge crowd. This is one of the biggest crowds in a long, long time, playoffs included. And a perfect night. You know, a team that's only 20 miles down the road, so no reason not to be here tonight. And, you know, this is going to be a fantastic shootout.
It is. And, Bill, you mentioned the big crowd. Would you have to go back to 2005 in that game against Marion to find a crowd that is this big?
Yeah, at least in that area. You know, this is top 5 probably all time in any crowd, you know, even the championship years. I mean, you know, you've got, you know, what helps that is we've got the huge West Delaware crowd over here. These bleachers, I don't know, you can maybe squeeze a few people in over here. You start getting them shoulder to shoulder. But you look over on that visitor side, and it's pretty rare that visitor side's full. That's the old home side, and it's pretty well full. You look along the fence lines from end zone are pretty well filled up. So, you know, great crowd here tonight, and should have us a heck of a game.
We will talk to you throughout the game, buddy boy.
All righty. Have a good one, guys.
Absolutely. Independence comes in 7-0, 5-0 in District 3 play as they beat Charles City last week 40-18. 7-0 for the first time in a very long time, I believe, 1975 or 43?
43.
43. Yep. 1943, the Mustangs qualified for the playoffs for the second straight year and are third in school history. They're 0-2 in playoff appearances. 14 sophomores, 10 juniors, 16 seniors make up the Mustang roster. Head coach Justin Putz, in his first season as the head coach of Independence, he took over as the head coach in week 9 last season, led the Mustangs to the playoffs, and has an 8-1 overall record, as 13-6 overall, as he's 8-1 in Independence. 13-6 overall, as he spent one season as the head coach at Louisa Muscatine, led the Falcons to the playoffs in 2013. He is a graduate, 2005 graduate of EDCO, and played baseball at Wartburg College. His assistant coaches are Brian Locker and Ben Zizes. Clint Hospodarski, Dwayne Mathis, Jack Gitkin, and Matt Shannon. As the last meeting was last year with these two teams on October 17th, Mustangs 10-0, won 10-0 in that game. The Hawks lead the overall series between these two teams 51-47-3. The Hawks will receive the opening kick, and coming up will be Coy Russell. He's going to run the reverse to Owen Ward. He's got it at the 25, up to about the 27-28 yard line. That's where the Hawks offense will start first and 10. And up front for the Hawks, Colin Weber, Blake Schrader, Sam Johnson, Colin Brown, Spencer Barron. The backs and receivers, John Nagel, Owen Ward, Tyler Kelly, Sam Maloney. Your running back is Coy Russell, and quarterback, senior Max Ridenour. As the Hawks come set on first and 10 here, they have it at their own 28-yard line. Max Ridenour, shotgun formation, two receivers to the left, one here on the near side. The give is to Russell on first and 10. He bounces up off one up to the 31-yard line. Pick up a three there, and it'll bring up second down and 7. This Independence defense up front, senior Matt McMillan, Lane McMartin, Isaiah Miller, and Alec Moore Norris. Linebackers are Colin Butzloff, Luke House, Jake Jewell, and Andrew Wright. And cornerbacks are Drew Davis, Cyrus Butters. Free safety is Nick Holt. The give again is to Russell up the middle. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, still pushing forward, as he's going to push forward for a couple, and it'll bring up third down. It was Matt McMillan on the stop for Independence, and it'll bring up third down and 6 yards for the Hawks. They have it. They give him the 32. So here's Max Ridenour on third, and they're going to look to throw. Ridenour now under pressure. He avoids one tackler, and he's going to step up, looking to throw. He's looking for Nagel, and he's got it around midfield. John Nagel with the reception. Ridenour felt the pressure of Matt McMillan coming, but coming up and making the stop for the Mustangs was Drew Davis, the cornerback. It'll be first and 10 West Delaware at the 50-yard line.
Yeah, and Max threw that exactly where he needed to. He had to float it over the defender, and John did a good job, that 6'5", 6'6", frame of just planting himself in the middle of the defender. So nice concentration there by John Nagel, bringing in, giving the Hawks the first down.
Quick start here for the Hawks as they come set, shotgun formation. Next to Ridenour is Russell. As Ridenour is going to keep it himself on the zone read. He crosses midfield down near the 30-yard line. As the West Delaware coaching staff looking for a hit out of bounds, but to no avail. It's a first down West Delaware at the Independence 33-yard line. As we didn't get a chance to mention our honorary captain here tonight, as it is Jim Wickman. He's a 1966 graduate of West Delaware. He's been a barber in Manchester for 45 years. He and his wife, Shirley, also a WD graduate, have lived in the Manchester area for 43 years and have two children who were both West Delaware graduates. The give is to Russell on first and 10. He crosses,
hang on to it,
down inside the 30 to about the 26, 27-yard line of Independence. As Jim and Shirley's son, Chris, and daughter, Lori, both, as we mentioned, both West Delaware graduate. He has three grandchildren. He's been a chain gang member for about 15 years and loves to follow the Hawks to all their road games. He has not missed a West Delaware football game, home or away, in 30 years.
Awesome, just awesome.
And he was our honorary captain, and he's back on the chain gang tonight. As Ridenour looks to throw on second down, he's got a man across the middle. This is Maloney. He sidesteps one, and he gets it down inside the 20-yard line as he's brought down out there. Finally wrapped up by Luke House for the Mustangs, and it is good for a West Delaware first down. So the Hawks continuing to move here.
You talk, Jamie, just when you think you get Russell and Ridenour stopped, then they throw the ball to Sam Maloney, who's second and 3A in receiving yards. So the Hawks have weapons all over the field.
First and 10 Hawks at the 18-yard line. They give us to Russell, and he runs up the middle, runs right into Jake Jewell, the senior for the Mustangs, as he is going to be brought down after a gain of one there. And a big hello to everybody listening tonight, wherever you may be. I know we've got some former Hawks listening in tonight that are playing college football. This time the Hawks are going to throw to Owen Ward down the sideline. He gets it around the first down marker as he's going to be run out of bounds over there by Nick Holt, as it's going to be real close to a first down for the Hawks. Let's see what they do here. Are they going to move the chains? Is it going to be first and goal, or? Mm-hmm. Or is it going to be third and short?
Looks like they're trying.
I don't know what they're doing. The chain gang's moving. They still have third down. It is going to be first and goal for the Hawks from the 8-yard line of Independence. Now the Hawks run a power formation. They're going to run Coy Russell behind Colin Weber off the left side, and he's going to get down inside the 5-yard line. As coming up and making the stop, for the Mustangs was Lane McMartin. First and second goal for the Hawks from the 4-yard line. Ridenour keeps this one himself. He fights forward down near the goal line.
Yes.
And it's going to be a West Delaware touchdown. With 8:34 left to go in the first quarter, the Hawks take the lead here, 6-0. And now we're going to see that swinging gate formation that the Hawks have come out here for the last few weeks. As the Mustangs quickly trying to huddle it up, they're going to throw, and it's going to be caught. But there is a penalty marker on the field. The thing is, with that, you have to still have the same number of guys lined up on the line.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure the Hawks did that. The pass was incomplete, looking for Owen Ward, I believe, over there. It's going to be offsides against the Hawks. That's declined. Hawks lead it 6-0 here with 8:34 left to go in this first quarter. We will take a break and come right back. You're listening to West Delaware Football from KMCH Sports.
Bob Steven Motors in Manchester proudly supports all area athletes. Bob Steven Motors is your locally owned and operated GM dealer in Manchester. Visit them on the web at bobstevenmotors.com.
A great night out awaits you at Heart Ridge Golf Course. Join us for Taco Tuesday and our Thursday night specials featuring roasted chicken. Watch the Iowa games with 50 cent wings and drink specials at Heart Ridge, north of Manchester on 195th Street.
Dunlap Motors in Independence with Chevy Buick and certified pre-owned Chevy Buick GMC and nearly 300 new and used cars and trucks in stock. They have big town inventory with small town service. Stop and say hi. That's Dunlap Motors in downtown Independence. And go to DunlapMotorsIndy.com. That's DunlapMotorsIndy.com.
Back into Manchester, the Hawks leading the Mustangs 6-0 with 8:34 left to go in this first quarter. Deep to receive this kick for Independence is Mason Wood and Drew Davis. It's going to be Davis who's going to pick it up, about bounced over his head at the 10-yard line. He's going to go off to the left side. He's going to be wrapped up. Aaron Demmer is going to bring him down at about the 26-yard line, and that's where the Mustangs will start with it here, first and 10. We want to thank our player of the game sponsor here tonight, the Okoboji Grill in Independence. 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence, Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet. We will pick a player of the game from both teams at the end of this contest here tonight, so stay tuned to that. Brought to you by Okoboji Grill in Independence. The Mustangs come set. We'll get to their offense here shortly, as they will come set. Nick Holt, the quarterback here, as they're going to run a power formation here against the Hawks. Holt is going to drop back to pass. He throws downfield, got him, overshoots the intended receiver as he was looking for Spencer Pink across the middle, and incomplete. Up front for the Mustangs is Andrew Wright, Alec Norris, Lane McMartin, Luke House, and Sam Rappin. Your receivers are Nick Steger, Colin Bootsloff, Spencer Pink. Your H-back is Matt McMillan. Running back is Jake Jewell. And the quarterback is Nicholas Holt. It'll be 2nd and 10 for the Mustangs. They have it at their own 26-yard line. Holt comes set. He's going to run it this time. He's running up the middle, and he's going to be dropped in the backfield. Eric Vasky comes up and makes the stop. And now Eric Vasky is getting a talk to by our official, as kind of stood over Nick Holt that time. As our officiating crew here tonight, we had them a couple weeks ago here against Charles City. Dennis Rima, Wayne Cusick, Tom Miner, Randy Mesher, and Mark Wiley. It'll be 3rd down and 11 here for the Mustangs. A loss of 1 on that play as Holt looks to throw. He rolls to his right, throws downfield, got a man out there. It's going to be caught. This is going to be Nick Steger at the Mustang 41-yard line, and that's going to be good for an Independence first down. This West Delaware defense. Up front is John Nagel, Caleb Sparks, Eric Vasky, and Kyle McGrain. Your linebackers are Bennett Cole, Colin Weber, and Brett Roush. Cornerbacks are Kyle Curley and Sam Maloney, and your safeties are Casey Winger and Owen Ward. 1st and 10 Mustangs at their own 41-yard line. Nicholas Holt comes set, senior quarterback. has done a lot for the Mustangs this year. This time, they give us to Jewell up the middle as Jewell crosses the 45 to about the 46-yard line where he's brought down out there by Brett Roush on the stop. Nick Holt comes in here passing. He's 66 for 111 for 1,088 yards, 4 interceptions, 10 touchdowns, but rushing the ball, he's carried it 205 times for 1,203 yards and 19 touchdowns on the season. So a pickup of 6 there for Jewell, and it's 2nd and 4. Holt's going to take the high snap. He corrals it, and he's going to take off up the middle. That's coming up to meet him was Eric Vasky and Bennett Cole, but it's going to be good for a Independence first down at the West Delaware 47-yard line. So the Mustangs starting their opening drive similar to the way the Hawks came out in that first drive. As Holt comes set, 1st and 10 Mustangs. They have it at the Hawk 47. Holt's going to keep it himself. He's going to be wrapped up. And coming up and making the stop for the Hawks was John Nagel and Colin Weber.
Well, you talk, Jamie, about Holt. He's 10th in Class 3A in passing yards, 3rd in rushing yards, and 2nd in total points. So, you know, he is the focal point of this offense. So the Hawks obviously he's the main target there for this Hawk defense.
Colin Weber, 3rd leading tackler for the Hawks here, 29 and a half tackles on the season, as it's going to be 2nd and 9 for the Mustangs. As Holt comes set, he looks to pass. He throws to the right. He's got a man out there looking for Spencer Pink. Overshot Pink as Sam Maloney was right there, but it falls incomplete. It'll be 3rd down and 9 here for the Mustangs.
Holt's got some pretty good zip on his ball, Jamie. He throws a really nice ball. So these receivers, with it being a little chillier tonight, you know, his receivers are going to have to do a good job of looking the ball into their hands and whatnot. But big 3rd down here early on in this game with 6 minutes to go. Big 3rd down here for this Hawks defense.
6:01 left to go in this first quarter. The Hawks lead 6-0. Holt looks to pass, throws to his right. He's got a man out there. It's Bootsflop. He's wrapped up at the 40, 41-yard line. That's coming over and making the stop there for the Hawks with Kyle Curley, short of the first down and the first decision-making time here for Coach Justin Putz and the Independence Mustangs, as it's 4th down and 4 yards to go as they have it at the Hawk 40-yard line. They're going to go for it. Holt comes set. 6-0. West Delaware leads it. Holt, shotgun formation. And now he looks to the sideline.
That D-line's got to be patient.
Got to be patient. Exactly. They only need 4, and offside gives them 5. He's still looking to the sideline. I think the Mustangs may call a timeout. No, they're gonna go for it. As Holt looks to pass, throws to his left. Incomplete. Incomplete as he was looking for Bootswap as it falls to the turf. And the Hawks will take over 1st and 10. At their own 40-yard line.
A nice job there by that Hawk defense, Jamie. I think they kind of confused Holt a little bit. His receivers went 5-10 yards further down the field. He threw the ball and was obviously way short. So great stand there by that Hawk defense. And now hopefully this offense come back out, keep gaining those yards, keep putting points on the board, because 6 isn't going to do it tonight. They're going to need a bunch to stay ahead of Independence.
The Hawks will come set 1st and 10, pistol formation. 1 receiver out to the left, 1 here in the slot on the near side of the field. As they give us to Russell, and he's going to be wrapped up as Jake Jewell, Matt McMillan combine on the stop right at the 40-yard line. No gain on that play. As the Hawks in their home uniforms, the black pants, gray tops with the black numbers and orange outline, gray helmets for the Mustangs. Their white uniforms, white shirts and gray pants, and maroon helmets with the eyes on the side of them. As the Hawks will come set, 2nd and 10. Right now, it looks to pass. Now he's running to his right, throws it down. He's got a man and incomplete. As he had a man open, that he was looking for Kelly. As he was looking for Tyler Kelly on the sideline and coming up and making a hit on Kelly as the ball arrived was Cyrus Butters, the sophomore for the Mustangs, and it's incomplete. It brings up 3rd and 10 for the Hawks.
Yeah, it looked like Max was going to do the delayed handoff and kind of broken play there a little bit and just couldn't get anybody open. So
you can hear the Mustang fans from the other side as the Hawks look to pass. Going down the field looking for Kelly, overshoots Kelly as Holt and Butters were there on the coverage. It brings up 4th and 10 for the Hawks as one of the Hawks loses his lid and will have to sit out. That's going to be Colin Weber. We'll sit out for this. I believe it'll be a punt here for the Hawks as it's 4th and 10. As these two teams, ranked number 2 and number 6, West Delaware number 2, the Mustangs number 6, 4 minutes and 30 seconds remain here in this first quarter, and the West Delaware Hawks lead 6-0. As Ridenour set to punt. His punt is away. Deep to receive is Colin Bootsloff. It's going to bounce at the 26-yard line. The Hawks will pick it up as it's going to deaden inside the 20 at the 19. Owen Ward picks it off. There is a penalty marker on the field at the 40-yard line. I love seeing this crowd here tonight, Aaron. Oh, you can hear it both sides on the defense. It looks like this penalty is going to be against the Hawks.
This is playoff atmosphere type stuff here, Jane.
Absolutely is. When the Hawks were on defense, you heard it on this side. And when the Mustangs were facing, or the Hawks had a 3rd and 10, you could hear it from the other side as these two crowds. And it just doesn't, it's not just in the stands. Bill mentioned the stands on the far side are packed. I don't know if it'd be tough to find a place to squeeze in along any of the fence line here at Brown Field, as there's that many people here tonight, as the Hawks will repunt it. So the Mustangs will make the Hawks punt over after the holding penalty as Ridenour punts it again. He gets off a high booming punt. Bootsloff is going to take it. The ball's on the ground, but he recovers it at the 36-yard line. As coming up for the Hawks on that play was Sam Johnson, as it's going to be 1st and 10 Mustangs. They have it at their own 36.
Yeah, beautiful punt there by Max. Actually, that was a better punt than the last one, even though he had to re-kick. So nice punt there by Max. So defense comes back out. See if they can repeat that first drive by the Mustangs.
As Nicholas Holt comes set, shotgun formation. He rolls to his right, following Jewell. Now he's going to get to the outside. He's tripped up and stays on his feet, still on his feet down the sideline, and he's got room to run. And he's going to be brought down at the West Delaware 45-yard line. It's finally bringing him down for the Hawks. On that far side was Caleb Sparks, but he got to that sideline, made a couple Hawks miss, and he runs in and gets it to the West Delaware. They're going to give it the 32-yard line, so it'll be 1st and 10 Mustangs. A nice run there by Nicholas Holt.
Yeah, he did a good job, like you said, just getting to that far sideline. I thought he would stop at least twice.
That senior quarterback making plays to give us to Jewell, and he's going to be wrapped up, tackled immediately at the line of scrimmage by Colin Weber. After a short gain, it'll be 2nd down and about 9 yards. Don't forget, stay tuned to KMC after our game here tonight for this week's area online and playback game of the week, as tonight Western Dubuque takes on Solon down in Solon. Join Kevin Shookman and Dan McClain with the call on that one right here on Mix 94.7. 6-0 West Delaware leads here, 3:20 to go in the first quarter. Nicholas Holt comes set, shotgun formation. They send Matt McMillan in motion. They're going to follow McMillan off to the left side. Holt keeps it himself, and he's going to be brought down as Bennett Cole comes up and makes the stop as he's down inside the 30-yard line to about the 27 of West Delaware, and it'll bring up 3rd down and 6, a gain of 3 there for Holt.
Really going to have to get wrap up tonight if you're a Hawk defender. You know, Holt's really elusive, and he's able to squirt out of tackles, so Hawks are going to have to wrap up and gang tackle.
As the Mustangs come set on 3rd and 6, 2:40 left to go. First quarter, Hawks leading 6-0. Holt keeps it himself up the middle. He's going to be dropped. I believe he's going to be short of the first down. He got to the 25 as falling on top of him there. And making the stop was Caleb Sparks. Colin Weber also on the bottom of that pile. It'll bring up 4th down and 2 yards here for the Mustangs with 2:20 remaining in the first quarter.
The second fourth down attempt here for the Mustangs. Last time the Hawks did a good job of defending the pass, so you probably expect a run here if you're the Hawk defense.
4th and 2 for the Mustangs. Holt comes set. He's going to run it to the right side. He's going to be...
He didn't get it.
It's going to be close. Eric Vasky, Colin Weber combined on the stop there. Was he short? He was short of the first down. For the 2nd drive for the Mustangs, in as many attempts, they turn the ball over on downs. It'll be West Delaware 1st and 10 from their own 23-yard line. So a nice defensive stand by that Hawk defense once again. The Mustangs have gotten into West Delaware territory, but haven't been able to get over that hump and put it into the end zone to try to tie this thing up. The Hawks lead 6-0 with 2:01 left to go in first quarter. First and 10, the Hawks will come set. Shotgun formation. The fake to Russell. Ridenour keeps it himself, and he's going to be wrapped up as Jake Jewell drops him right around the line of scrimmage. As we do have an injured Mustang on the field, as that is going to be Luke House. He was credited for half a tackle there on Ridenour, so he is down on the field as they tend to him. As those two, that's Jake Jewell, second leading tackler for the Mustangs on the season. As we have other games tonight, as mentioned, Western Dubuque at Solon, New Hampton is at Beckman, Anamosa is at Union. The Blue Raiders are ranked number 4 in Class 2A. Cascade is at Mount Vernon tonight. Tipton is at Monticello. Macoka Valley hosts Easton Valley. Lisbon right now, I believe they were scoreless with Edco after the first quarter, as that game is in Lisbon. East Buchanan hosts Northwind. Starmont hosting Postville tonight. Charles City's at Decorum. Vint Shelsburg in Class 3, District 3, is hosting Clear Creek and Manum. And Crestwood is at Waverly Shell Rock. That is a very slow Luke House going off the sideline, being helped off by two coaches. So we wish him the best.
Absolutely.
And, hopefully he can get healed up on that. And hopefully nothing too serious over there on that Independence sideline is a big part of this defense for the Mustangs. It'll be 2nd and 9. They gave Ridenour 1 yard on that last play. They've got it at their own 24, do the Hawks. As the Hawks will run Russell, as he's going to run it, cut back a couple times as he's going to get it up to the 26-yard line. He'll pick up 2, bring up 3rd and 7, but you can see Russell doing what Coy Russell does. He's looking for anything. He went right, and then he came back to the left and tried scratching out some yards. It'll bring up 3rd and 7 for the Hawks. 3 wide receivers to the right for the Hawks as they come set in the pistol formation. Ridenour looks to throw, looking for Ward. He's got him, picks it up off the turf. They're going to call it incomplete. They're going to say that pass was incomplete as Ward had to go down and tried to pick it up off the turf before it hit the ground, but incomplete pass, and it'll bring up 4th down and 7 for the Hawks.
And Owen did what he could. You know, he wanted to stay on his feet to try and get some momentum to gain, get, pick up the first down, just couldn't do it. Ball hit the ground, forced the Hawks here to punt for the 2nd time tonight.
Max Ridenour, the quarterback for the Hawks, 58 of 115 passing on the year for 1,390 yards. 1 interception and 17 touchdowns, and he's going to punt this one away. Busloff has it. He's going to call for the fair catch at his own 37-yard line. Nice punt there by Ridenour, trying to switch the field for the Hawks. And we'll see what this Independence Mustang offense can do here, as they've done a great job of getting down to the West Delaware, you know, inside the 35 of West Delaware, but have had 2 turnover on downs here as they have not been able to convert on 4th down attempts.
Well, the big play was the whole run, you know, the 30-40-yard run that he had there. Other than that, the Hawks have done a really nice job, like you said, of containing this Independence offense. And so that's going to be the key. We knew it coming in. West Delaware was going to have to focus on Holt. He squirted out for 1 big play. But other than that, the Hawks have done a good job.
Lane McMartin tying his cleat down there as the center gets set to snap it to Nicholas Holt, the quarterback for the Mustangs. Holt comes set. Hawks lead 6-0 here in the first quarter. Throws across the middle. He's got Busloff. And that's good coverage there by Owen Ward as that pass falls incomplete. Busloff had it, but Owen Ward got an arm in there and knocked it away. 56 seconds remain in this first quarter. Again, West Delaware leads 6-0 here as the Mustangs face a 2nd down and 10.
Yeah, the timing, Owen Ward's timing on that was perfect. He waited until the ball hit the receiver's hand, and he just came in and chopped it away. So nice job there by Owen Ward.
So the Mustangs will face a 2nd and 10. No running back, so an empty backfield here. Shotgun formation. They send Jewell in motion. They're going to fake the handoff to Jewell, and Holt's got it up the middle. He's got room to run as 2 Hawks chasing him. He's got it at the 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown Independence. Jake Jewell from 63 yards out. Nicholas Holt, the quarterback keeper, 63 yards for the Mustang touchdown, and it's tied up 6-6 with 45 seconds left to go in quarter number 1.
And Holt Jewell in motion. Holt faked it to him, that kind of wildcat look, and the defense started pushing over towards the far sideline, and Holt just kept it. So Hawks are gonna. That's one that the Hawks will have to keep in the memory bank tonight.
The Mustangs show their swinging gait now as They will come set to kick this one for an extra point. On to kick for the Mustangs is Mark Thompson, senior kicker. And I believe they have too many players on the field. They do, as one of the Mustangs tried to run off the field. As too many players on the field, that'll be a penalty against the Mustangs. And it'll back up this extra point kick 5 yards. Officials are sorting this out, it is going to be legal procedure against the Mustangs. Too many players on the field as one trotted off, and I don't know who realized that he wasn't supposed to be in there, but he took off, and the penalty is called. So an extra point now for the Mustangs as it backs that up to the 8-yard line. So a 25-yard extra point is no good. It went right. It's tied up 6-6, 45 seconds remaining in quarter number one. Hawks and Mustangs, number two versus number six, week number eight. Both teams undefeated. You're listening to it right here on Eastern Iowa Sports Station, Mix 94.7 KMCH.
At Precision Collision, we are committed to providing you with high-quality auto body repair and paint refinishing. Our expertly trained technicians can repair all accidental damage and get you back on the road in no time. Come visit me, Jeff, for a free estimate. We are located along Highway 20 at the Delaware Turnoff. Precision Collision, one call does it all, quality guaranteed.
Wapsie Valley Creamery in Independence is a family-owned business dedicated to serving family-owned dairy farms in Northeast Iowa, Northwest Illinois, and Southwest Wisconsin since 1906. Wapsie Valley Creamery Incorporated in Independence, partners in excellence.
When it comes to financial planning, most financial companies focus on your income. At Northwestern Mutual, we focus on your outcome. It takes the right financial partner who cares as much about your future as you do, building a financial plan to meet your life's priorities and helping you achieve the financial security you're after. Focus on your financial outcome with Northwestern Mutual. Contact me, Mitch Payton, or Matt Schulte today. You and Northwestern Mutual, stronger together.
Back into Brown Field, Hawks and Mustangs tied up 6-6. Jamie Vasky, Aaron Pleen, and Bill Logan back with you here. Mark Thompson to kick away for the Mustangs. It's going to be taken by Owen Ward. They're going to pitch to Coy Russell at the 15-yard line. Coy's waiting a block. He's got one at the 25, cuts back at the 30. He's still on his feet, pushing down the sideline. They're going to see stepped out of bounds at the 32-yard line, and that's where the Hawks will take over first and 10. Aaron, the Mustangs on the board here.
Yeah, after that... The first touchdown drive for the Hawks was a 4-yard touchdown run by Max Ridenour, and then just now Nick Holt with the 63-yard touchdown run. Two plays, missed extra point, ties this game 6-6 with 36 seconds to go here in this first quarter.
So Max Ridenour, senior quarterback, trots onto the field here with the new play from the coaching staff as they start first and 10 from their own 32-yard line. 36 seconds remain in quarter number one. As Ridenour comes set, shotgun formation. He looks to pass, throws downfield, got a man, overshoots him, in and out of the fingers, I guess, of Sam Maloney, as Drew Davis was there on the coverage. But I think Maloney just couldn't get his hands around it. He threw a bullet,
And
it falls incomplete. Second and 10 for the Hawks from their own 32.
Well, we talked about it when Independence had the ball. It's a little chillier tonight than it has been. Probably the coldest game of the year so far. So getting adjusted to that, these receivers are going to have to really concentrate.
The Hawks will throw on second and 10. Ridenour rolls to his right, looking downfield. He's looking. He overshoots Nagel as he threw it out of bounds into the Hawks bench. Cyrus Butters on the coverage there for the Mustangs, and it'll be third and 10 for the Hawks. Very similar teams when it comes to looking at how many points they've given up on the year. The Hawks have given up 102 points against opponents. The Mustangs, 106. So it's that close between these top 10 ranked teams. Third and 10 for the Hawks. Low snap. Ridenour picks it up. Now he's going to run to his right, and he avoids one tackler, and Owen Ward That was Owen Ward.
Yep.
As he went down to catch it, it looked like he might have made the catch, but the ball squirted out, and it'll bring up fourth down and 10 for the Hawks from their own 32-yard line.
Yeah, just the ball, if the ball would have been thrown about another yard further, I think Owen could have had it and picked up additional yardage, but unfortunately Max has thrown it and kind of threw it off one foot and threw it short. So Hawks punting here for the third time tonight, so this offense hopefully can get on track.
Ridenour will punt as it's going to bounce at the 34-yard line, and Bootsloff is going to pick it up on the run with momentum, and he's going to bring it out to about the 45-yard line, and he's going to be brought down as Colin Brown lays the big hit on Bootsloff, and the Mustangs will take over first and 10 from their own 43-yard line. As we'll take a look at some of the scores that we have on this Friday night. As Solon leading Western Dubuque 14-0 at the end of the first quarter. Union leading, Anamosa leading Union 14-0 that game in the first quarter. As we're back to action here, Holt, a bubble screen to Bootsloff off to the left side. He's going to get it out to the 45-yard line where a host of Hawks come up and make the stop. As Bennett Cole, Bennett Cole wraps him up, and there's a little extracurricular activity out there between the Hawks and the Mustangs, and that's going to do it for our first quarter as the Hawks and Mustangs tied at 6. We'll be back with the second quarter right after this. You're listening to West Delaware Football from KMCH Sports.
Crop Production Services in Winthrop, your complete package for chemicals, seed, fertilizer, agronomy, soil sampling, and custom applications. Make sure you trust the experts at CPS in Winthrop with you every step of the way.
American Trust and Savings Bank wishes all area athletes and coaching staff continued success. American Trust and Savings Bank, with locations in Dyersville, Farley, Dubuque, and Des Moines. Simply better banking. Check them out at americantrust.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Back into Brown Field as we get prepared to start quarter number two. And we've had a good, what a first quarter that was. It's a 6-6. We'd expect nothing less between these two top 10 ranked teams here tonight as the Hawks get set to go on defense. As I mentioned, Casey Wenger in the game for the Hawks earlier. Matt McMahon back from his shoulder injury. As he's on the field here tonight for the Hawks. Also good to see Caleb Whitman down on the sideline again here for the Hawks. He's in his wheelchair as he broke his leg in, I believe it was week two. It was here on Brown Field against Maquoketa. As it'll be second down and 8 here for the Mustangs. The ball at their own 45-yard line as Nick Holt comes set. Shotgun formation. The fullback is McMillan. The running back is Jewell. Holt comes set. He's going to roll to his right. It's a design run. He avoids one tackler, and he gets tackled by the second one. As Eric Vasky chased him to his right, he cut back and ran into Caleb Sparks. Vasky and Sparks combine on the stop all the way back to the 39-yard line. That's a loss of 6 on that play for Holt, and it'll bring up 3rd and 14 for the Mustangs with 11:35 left to go in this second quarter. 6-6 is our score. A great matchup here between West Delaware and Independence. The Highway 20 battle here tonight as Nick Holt comes set for a 3rd and 14. Ball at their own 39. He looks to pass. He pumps one. Now he avoids one, and he's going to throw it away as he's hit, and the ball's going to be caught by Bootsloff. A great catch by Bootsloff, and that's going to be close to a Mustang first down.
Might be.
As Brett Roush and Kyle Curley were there. And that's going to be real close. Well,
they marked
that's
that.
Going to be, I don't think it is. Cool. They're going to give it a first down for the Mustangs. 1st and 10 for the Mustangs, and what a play by Nick Holt. As he was getting hit from behind, he threw that ball downfield. It wobbled in the air, but Colin Bootsloff comes up and makes the stop. Empty backfield this time for the Mustangs as it looks like Jewell will go in motion here. And they're going to fake the handoff to Jewell. Holt keeps it himself. He's going to be met up the middle right around the West Delaware 45-yard line.
That's the same play that Holt scored the touchdown on. They sent Jewell in motion, kind of that wildcat, and like he did on the touchdown run, Holt kept it, and the Hawks were on top of it and prevented him from getting any more than the 2 or 3 yards that he got.
Kyle McGrain on the stop for the Hawks. It'll be a pickup of 3 on that play by Holt. It's 2nd and 7 for the Mustangs from the West Delaware 44-yard line. As Holt comes set, shotgun formation. The fullback is McMillan. As he looks to throw, he throws to his left. He's got a man out there. That's Spencer Pink, and he's wrapped up at the 41 of West Delaware. Sam Maloney brings him down. It'll bring up third and about 5 yards here for the Mustangs, maybe four. Third and four for Independence, right at the West Delaware 40-yard line.
Nice job by Sam of making sure Pink couldn't get any further after he caught the ball. So another big third down here, Jamie, in the second quarter, even though it's early. Big third down here for both these teams.
Absolutely. Third and four. Probably four down territory here for the Mustangs. Holt keeps it himself up the middle. Bounces out to the right. He's going to be wrapped up by Bennett Cole at about the West Delaware 35-yard line, and that's going to move the chains again. First and 10 Independence from the West Delaware 35.
And just watching Holt here, Jamie, this first quarter and a half or whatever, he's one of those guys that is just hard to get. You're never going to get a good shot on him because he's always moving. He's always shifting around and stuff, so. This is a good characteristic of a good football player.
Leading passer and leading rusher for the Mustangs on this team. First and 10 for the Mustangs. They send Bootsloff in motion. The pitch to Bootsloff. He gets it off the right side. He's going to be wrapped up and dropped in the backfield. Bennett Cole on the stop for the Hawks at the 36-yard line.
And you know, Jamie, teams that try and go sideline to sideline against the Hawks have a really difficult time because the Hawks are fast and they flow to the ball well. It's when, you know, I struggle to watch it every time because teams think that they can go sideline to sideline and the Hawks just do a great job of playing team defense.
No gain on that play. They're going to be second down and 10 Mustangs from the West Delaware 35-yard line. Hawks have got to try to keep their composure out here on the field because there's some talking going on afterwards as Holt's pass falls incomplete. He was looking for McMillan. McMillan hadn't turned around yet, and the pass falls behind McMillan. It'll bring up third down and 10, but what I was saying is there's some extracurricular talking going on at the bottom of these piles, and we've seen Bootsloff get up once unhappy, and the officials were pointing to one of the Hawk defenders on two plays ago, so just got to keep calm here. Come out here and play football because we can't afford to lose anybody on this defense. Third down and 10 for the Mustangs. Holt comes set. Shotgun formation. He looks to pass. Looking for McMillan. On the sideline, overshoots him. Kyle Curley was there on the coverage for the Hawks. It brings up fourth and 10 for Independence.
And a good job there. The Hawks brought a little bit of a blitz, brought a guy from the edge, and just kind of rushed Holt a little bit, and that little bit forced the overthrow. So good job there by this Hawk defense after one or two first downs there by Independence. So kind of an interesting territory too. Fourth and 10 on the 35.
Looks like they're setting up for Nick Holt to punt. We've got a tie ball game here with 8:24 left to go in this second quarter. As Nick Holt deep to punt, he stands at his own 47-yard line, or the Hawk 47-yard line. As he tries to deaden this ball, he shoots for the corner, and it's going to bounce and go. It's not going to go into the end zone. The Mustangs are going to down it at the one-yard line. Ooh. As a great punt there by Nicholas Holt, and the Hawks will start first and 10 at their own one-yard line. Great punt there by Nick Holt.
Yeah, just a great job of angling it towards that far side, towards the Independence bench, and the ball just kind of bounced and just went straight up in the air and then deadened there for them to get down and get it. So the Hawk offense has their work cut out for them here on their own one-yard line.
Been struggling to move the ball after that first drive of the game has this Hawk offense. We'll see if they can get something going here. This Independence defense has been outstanding as the Independence crowd comes to their feet across the way. As, again, Brown Field is at capacity tonight. Hawks cut line up under center. Ridenour is just going to run straight forward. I think he might have got out to near the 5-yard line, so that'll give the Hawks some breathing room here. With 8 minutes left to go in the second quarter, we've got a tie ball game, 6-6, between the Hawks and the Mustangs. As Isaiah Miller makes the stop for Independence, as the Hawks will come set, shotgun formation, Ridenour running behind Russell off the right side. He's going to be wrapped up as Jake Jewell wraps him up by his feet at about the 7-yard line. It'll bring up third down in about 5 yards here. We'll call it 4 yards for the Hawks. So finally, they've got some breathing room here. See if they can convert here on third down and four. Call it three, a long 3 yards here for the Hawks as they send one man out here to the near side of the field. One receiver to the right. Ridenour comes set. They give it to Russell. He's going to go off to the left side. He's going to fight forward. He doesn't get back to the 10-yard line. He's going to be short of the first down. They needed to get to about the 11, and it'll be fourth down and short here for the Hawks as they have it at their own 9-yard line.
And just not enough push there by that Hawk offensive line to pick up those extra 2 yards. So hopefully Max can get off a good punt here.
Looks like the Hawks are going to go for it here. A risky move early in this ball game. I think the Hawks may stall and call a timeout, trying to draw the Mustangs offside to no avail. As the Hawks call a timeout with 6:31 left to go in this second quarter. We're tied up at 6. West Delaware and Independence, you're listening to it right here on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Adams Family Furniture in downtown Independence has over 43 years in the furniture business. You can shop for quality brand names like Lazy Boy, Broyhill, Chromecraft, Peters Revington, just to name a few. Shop Adams Family Furniture in downtown Independence with free delivery. They will never be undersold on light quality furniture.
Sight and good vision is very easy to take for granted until it is taken away. Advanced Eye Care Associates of Eastern Iowa is here to help you. Advanced Eye Care Associates of Eastern Iowa is located at 105 East Butler Street in Manchester and at 1113 West 3rd Street in Vinton. Your vision is our primary focus.
Back in to Brown Field. 6-6 is our score. The Hawks look like they're going to punt this one away now, and Colin Butzloff is going to go deep to receive for the Mustangs. Max Ridenour stands right at his own end zone. He gets this one away. It heads towards the West Delaware sideline. It's going to bounce and go out of bounds at the West Delaware 44-yard line, and that's where the Mustangs, they're going to call it the 45. That's where the Mustangs will start first and 10. For the West Delaware Hawks right now, they really got to get some offense going because that defense is really doing the defense has done its part tonight, but the offense after that first drive hasn't been able to get going. And Independence the same way. Their offense has looked good at times, but, again, their defense is keeping them in this game.
Well, and as you'd expect, now it's turning into a battle of field position. Independence has flipped the field on the Hawks and are going to start this drive at the West Delaware 45-yard line. So, puts this defense again in a tough position, but we've seen this time and time again where the Hawks have stepped up.
6:24 left to go, second quarter. The Mustangs will run Holt to the left side. He gets a block from Jake Jewell, and he's still on his feet at the 20, still moving forward down near the 10-yard line before he's run out of bounds as Sam Maloney brought him down. There's two penalty markers in the Independence backfield as we see two Mustangs. Now the rest of the Mustangs are kind of heading back this way. As the Mustangs sealed the edge, but I think they got some help from a hold, and it is holding against the Mustangs, so it'll back them up and bring up first and long here for Independence.
The Hawks needed that, Jamie, because that was a Holt had a lot of green in front of him and a blocker as well. So fortunately for the Hawks, and we talked about this in the pregame, you and I off air, penalties and turnovers were going to be a major factor in this game tonight, especially with two teams ranked in top 10, and
starting to see that field position could become a factor in this game. You don't say that much in a high school football game, but so far that's been the case. The Hawks have had not good field position. The Mustangs have had good field position to give us to Jewell up the middle. He crosses back midfield, balls on the ground, and the Hawks have it at the 45-yard line as it's going to be picked up by Matt McMahon. He makes his return to the Hawks lineup, and he picks up the fumble of Jake Jewell. Hawks have it first and 10 at their own 45-yard line.
Oh, is that big or what? Oh, man.
And this is the best field position the Hawks have had in quite some time, as their drives here have started at their own 28, their own 40, their own 23, their own 32, and their own 1. This one at their own 45-yard line, first and 10. So they've got some breathing room here. Do the Hawks. They're going to run a power formation here as they've got two backs in front of Ridenour and Russell, and they look to pass. Right now, he looks down the field. He's looking for Maloney. Maloney's got it and then dropped it. Had the catch, but then dropped it. Great coverage out there by Drew Davis. As Ridenour put it right on the money, it looks like Maloney had hauled it in, but I think Drew Davis knocked it out after he had it. It'll bring up second down and 10.
I think, Jamie, the big thing right there is this: what you said. Max threw a beautiful ball there, and Sam ran under it like we've seen him do all year and just couldn't haul it in.
Second and 10. Ridenour looks to pass, fakes to Russell. Now he rolls out to his right. He's got it. He's under pressure. He's got to get rid of this ball, and he's going to step up, and he's going to be dropped and run out of bounds as Cyrus Butters is going to run him out of bounds. But a loss on that play, and it'll bring up third down and long here for the Hawks. As with 5:32 left to go in this second quarter, it's 6-6, a third and 12 upcoming for the Hawks back at their own 43-yard line.
You know, that first drive, Gene, we talked about, it looked like the Hawks were establishing the run. Coy ran it 2-3 times. Max had it for a couple, one or two nice big games there. And it looks like as if the Hawks have kind of went away from that or going more towards the air.
So the Hawks come out, empty backfield. Russell here on the near side. Shotgun formation for Ridenour. Screen is set up. They've got it. It's incomplete. Penalty marker on the field. They were looking late for Owen Ward, a very late flag coming from our near side official.
Right here.
It is. It is right here. As Dennis Rima, ineligible man downfield against the Hawks. That'll back them up. Again, at the end of tonight's game, we will pick a player of the game from each team. And that's brought to you by Okoboji Grill in Independence. 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence, Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet. Our player of the game sponsor here tonight between the Hawks and the Mustangs. It'll be fourth down as the Mustangs decline that penalty. Fourth and 12, 5:26 left to go in this first half. All tied up, 6-6. The second-ranked Hawks, the sixth-ranked Mustangs. Ridenour's punt. It's a good thing for the Hawks. Ridenour's been having a good punting night here as he's done quite a bit of it here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Fifth punt of the night for Max Ridenour. And again, you can find out what all of our area coaches have to say about tonight's games, as that's tomorrow morning at 9 on the Coach's Corner with Kevin Shookman. Following that will be the Hawkeye pregame show in progress. And then the Hawkeyes taking on the Northwestern Wildcats tomorrow in Evanston.
Big game.
Big game.
Big
11 o'clock game. Kick. You can hear it right here with Gary Dolphin, Ed Podolak, and Robbie Brooks on the Iowa Hawkeye Radio Network here on KMCH. As Holt keeps it himself, he's going to be wrapped up as Max Ridenour brings him down. Brett Roush wrapped him up by the feet and brings him down. It's going to be second down and 7, a 3-yard gain there by Nicholas Holt. Here with 5 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Great atmosphere for high school football here tonight, Aaron.
Absolutely.
You got to love it. These kids have got to love it, too, playing in front of a crowd like this. So much on the line. The Mustangs win, they win a district title. If the Hawks win tonight, they're one step closer to a district title with one district game remaining. Holt looks to throw on second down and 7. He throws across the middle. Defender fell down, and he finds McMillan still on his feet. Down to the West Delaware 20-yard line as he's going to be brought down by Sam Maloney. The West Delaware defender who was covering McMillan slipped up, and he fell down, and that left McMillan wide open, and he had plenty of room in front of him as it's going to be first and 10 Mustangs at the West Delaware 19-yard line.
And
nice catch and run by McMillan.
He did exactly what he just ran straight up the field, and Holt threw it on him and did a good job picking up a big play there for Indy.
The Hawks take a timeout here with 4:32 remaining in the second quarter. We'll take one as well. You're listening to West Delaware Football from KMCH Sports.
For over a century, Anderson has been helping families make their homes brighter, more comfortable, and more beautiful. They do it by making quality windows and doors, setting the bar high and raising it day after day, year after year, making Anderson the leader in doors and windows. Contact local vendor Delhi Lumber at 922-2404 for all of your window needs. Delhi Lumber, your authorized Anderson Windows dealer, has big town quality with small town service.
At Community Savings Bank, it's simple. Simply Free Checking comes with free debit cards, free online banking with bill pay, free mobile money, and free thank you gifts. Find out more about Simply Free Checking at one of our 7 locations or online at csbiowa.com. Community Savings Bank. Member FDIC.
The two teams atop Class 3, District 3 in action here tonight. West Delaware and Independence. Nicholas Holt takes this 1st-and-10 run up the middle. He keeps it himself, as tripping him up was Eric Vasky, and then he was brought down by a host of West Delaware defenders. We're tied up 6-6 here in the second quarter. 4:20 left to go in quarter number two, as both these teams undefeated in district action. Undefeated overall, both teams 7-0. The Mustangs are 5-0 in district play. The Hawks 4-0 in district 3 action. Holt comes set. 2nd down and 6. A 4-yard gain on 1st down. He looks to Spencer Pink on the far sideline. It falls incomplete. Sam Maloney was there on the coverage. Right behind the Hawks and the Mustangs is Decora. They're 3-1 in district play. Waverly, Shellrock, and Crestwood both 1-3 in district action, as they take on, they face each other tonight in Waverly. And Vic Shellsburg's 1-4, as Charles City is 0-4 in district play. The Mustangs come set. Holt is going to run it himself again, as Eric Vasky's going to come up from behind and make the tackle. Also there was Kyle Curley, as it's down at the 11-yard line, and that'll be good for another Independence 1st down here. So it'll be 1st and goal for the Mustangs from the Hawk 9-yard line, as Holt will come set. Shotgun formation. 2 receivers split out to the right. That's Bootsloff and Steger. 1 to the left is Spencer Pink. Holt comes set. Looks to throw. Looks to Pink as he threw it behind him. Threw it behind Spencer Pink as Sam Maloney was there on the coverage. It falls incomplete. He'll bring up 2nd down and goal.
And Holt, that pass is, that's the 3rd time now that I think we've seen Holt try to throw that slant to Pink, and all 3 times he's thrown it behind him. So that's one that the Hawks are going to have to keep an eye on.
So Holt comes set, 2nd down and goal for Independence. Jake Jewell stands next to him, shotgun formation. Holt keeps it himself. Caleb Sparks wraps him up, drops him back right at the line of scrimmage. So it'll bring up 3rd down and goal here for the Mustangs. So 3:10 remaining in the second quarter. This game tied up 6-6. Both teams scored. The Hawks tried a 2-point conversion. The Mustangs missed a 25-yard extra point after a penalty. Holt stands alone, shotgun formation. He takes the snap. He runs to his left. He looks to throw, throws to the sideline, and throws it away. And it'll be incomplete and bring up 4th down and goal here. Threw it over near Jake Reeves, taking pictures over there on that Independence sideline. Not sure he's got his ears on over there, his headset on tonight, but the Mustangs will come set and attempt a field goal here, as this will be a 25-yard field goal.
And I was
near the right hash mark. This is exactly where they were on that extra point attempt back in the first quarter. The hold is down by Nick Holt. The kick is up, and the Mustangs lead it 9-6 with 2:44 left to go in the second quarter. We'll take a break and come back. The Hawks and Mustangs here, week number 8, both 7-0. You're listening to it on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Pets Allowed in Independence, proud to support all area athletes, coaches, and fans. Pets Allowed has been your pet's lodging, grooming, and training specialist for over 16 years. Contact Pets Allowed at 319-334-7387, 319-334-PETS in Independence.
Jay's Auto Super Center on the Greater East End of Manchester has quality pre-owned vehicles, great financing options, and a full-service department, body shop, and detail department. See their full line of vehicles online at jsautosales.net. At Jay's Auto, customer satisfaction is their number one priority.
Back into Brown Field, the Mustangs lead the Hawks 9-6. 2:44 left to go, second quarter, as Zach Harris to kick off for the Mustangs. A little pooch kick. Kyle McGrain's going to take it at his own 29-yard line. He's still on his feet at the 40, still pushing forward, as he's going to be brought down around midfield. So the defensive end for the Hawks takes this one. The senior for West Delaware says, let me do it myself here, as he trots off the field, as the Hawks will start first and 10 at their own 47-yard line.
And we talked about field position, Jamie, and here we go again. The Hawks with really good field position, so this offense has to get on track here and help this defense out. The defense has played really well tonight. We need that Hawk offense to step up now.
Eight plays on that last drive for the Mustangs, and a 25-yard field goal by Mark Thompson puts the Mustangs up 9-6. As the Hawks come out shotgun formation, standing next to Max Reinauer is Coy Russell. The quick pass, bubble screen to Owen Ward. He's got room on the sideline. 45 of Independence, penalty marker down. And usually on a bubble screen like that, it's going to be holding. It's Coy C as our head official. It's going to be holding against the Hawks. That it is. Dennis Reimer makes our call there. Came here on the Hawks sideline, near side to us. 2:32 left to go, second quarter. So a nice catch and run there by Owen Ward is going to be negated, and it's going to back the Hawks up to their own 44-yard line now. So first down and 12. Well, first and 13 for the Hawks, as Tripp's receivers to the left, one on the far side for the Hawks. The bubble screen again. They're going to go right back to it. Ward has it around midfield, about the 49-yard line. So on first and 13, it ends up being about a gain of 2, and it will face second down and 8 for the Hawks. Here is 2 minutes and 28 seconds left to go in this second quarter. The Mustangs, after that 25-yard Mark Thompson field goal, lead the Hawks 9-6. Senior night at Brown Field. Hawks come set. The give is to Russell. He gets to the right side, and he can't get it. Gets to about midfield. They'll mark him down about the 50-yard line, just short. It'll bring up third down and 7 yards here for the Hawks.
And I think, you know, even though the Hawks are getting stuffed here in this first half, Jamie, on the run, I still think you got to stick with it, because eventually, and we've seen it this year, that pops loose. Coy or Max, one of these guys is going to pop one loose. So I think the Hawks got to stay with it, and eventually good things are going to happen.
Third down and 7 for the Hawks. 2 minutes till halftime. Reinauer looks to pass.
Heads up,
pressure's coming. He gets it away. And they're going to say it's incomplete, as Tyler Kelly was the recipient of that, and it falls on the ground, as on the coverage there for the Mustangs was Mason Wood. And it'll bring up fourth down and 7 for the Hawks, with a minute 48 left to go in the second quarter. So this Mustang defense giving the Hawks fits here, and you mentioned it up front. It's where it all begins. And the Mustang defensive front is outworking the West Delaware offensive front right now. Right now we're set to punt away on 4th and 7, a beautiful punt. Butters is going to watch this one bounce, and it's going to go out of bounds at about the 13 of Independence. So the Mustangs will start back at their own 13-yard line. It's the Hawks, I believe this is their worst starting field position of this ballgame, as the Mustangs lead the Hawks 9-6, as we're just before halftime. Waverly Shellrock leading Crestwood right now, as the score of that one is 14-6. That one's at halftime. So minute 39. Left to go in the first half here. Again, at halftime, we're going to talk with West Delaware freshman coach Bob Morris and our honorary captain Jim Wickman here tonight. Ball's on the ground as Holt fumbled the snap. He's going to pick it up, and it'll be at their own 10-yard line. Again, Bob Morris and his freshman victorious here tonight. What a game that was. You got to see a majority of that as well. The Hawks defeating Independence 22-20 to raise their record to 5-2. West Delaware sophomores last night over in Independence improved to 6-1-1 as they defeated Independence sophomores 30-6. Right now, the Independence varsity trying to turn the tide on those two games as they lead the Hawks here 9-6 with a minute left to go in the second quarter. And we'll talk to Jim Wickman, our honorary captain here tonight, and a penalty marker is delay of game against the Mustangs. We'll back them up 5 yards. So second and 12 turns into second and 17 as the ball is back at their own 5-yard line. With just under a minute left to go here in this second quarter. As Holt comes set, shotgun formation. Beside him is Jake Jewell. He's going to run it himself up the middle, and he's going to be wrapped up as Eric Vasky and Caleb Sparks combine on the stop there for the Hawks, and I believe Coach Coates comes out, and the Hawks take a timeout here with 52 seconds left to go. It's third down. Let's see where they – third and – now he's going to pick up a couple yards there. It's going to be third and 14 for the Mustangs. When we come back, you're listening to Hawk football tonight from Brown Field on Eastern Iowa Sports Station, Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Citizens State Bank is your locally owned, community-minded, and customer-oriented bank here to serve you. Choose one of the six convenient locations, including Monticello, Hopkinton, Manchester, Ryan, Strawberry Point, and Winthrop. Visit them at citizensstateonline.com. Community banking with people you know. Member FDIC.
Hi, this is Jamie Vasky at Donenwald LLC, your independent Lennox dealer in Manchester, encouraging you to plan ahead. Have us check your heating or air conditioning unit before you need it. For residential or commercial plumbing and heating needs and top quality Lennox furnaces and heating units, see Donenwald LLC on East Main Street in Manchester or give us a call at 927-2232.
Back into Brown Field, Mustangs lead 9-6. Third and 14 upcoming for Independence. 52 seconds remaining in quarter number two as the Mustangs on offense here. Hawk defense doing its job here tonight. The offense has been lacking. 72 yards on that first drive. They've got 94 total here as we near the end of the second quarter as Holt is going to keep this one himself, and he's going to be wrapped up out there by John Nagel at about the 10-yard line. So it's going to bring up fourth and 12 here for the Mustangs. It looks like they're going to have to punt it away as the play clock is lower than the game clock. So I think that's what the Hawk coaching staff wanted, was to just get a chance for a punt return.
Force them to punt it and make them make a play.
You may get on the Mustang side of the field as Tanner Wessels and Owen Ward stand back ready to receive this punt for the Hawks. The Mustangs will call a timeout here with 10 seconds remaining on the game clock here in quarter number two. Mentioned the Hawkeyes play Northwestern tomorrow down at Ryan Field in Evanston. The Iowa State Cyclones hosting TCU tomorrow. That's a 6 o'clock kick for the Cyclones and the UNI Panthers as they host Western Illinois. I believe that's homecoming tomorrow for the UNI Panthers.
Sure,
that's a 4 o'clock kick inside the Unidome. We'll take a look at that. All of our big schools in Iowa, and then we'll take a look at our Hawks in the NCAA segment here as our former West Delaware Hawks that are playing in college football tomorrow, as I believe all of them are in action. And let you know about the games last week, as we had former Hawks playing against each other last weekend up in Waverly. We'll tell you how that went. But we're 10 seconds away from halftime here from Brown Field, and the Mustangs clinging to that 9-6 lead over Independence as the Mustangs set to punt it away here. Fourth and 11 for Independence as Nicholas Holt set to punt it away as he stands in his own end zone. He gets off a punt. It's going to bounce. It's not going to bounce out of bounds. Owen Ward is going to pick it up, and he's going to step out of bounds with 4 seconds left, but he's going to have it at the Mustang 47-yard line. That's where the Hawks will have it first and 10, but probably one more play here for the Hawks in this first half. We'll see what they do, as I think this coaching staff is going to have to take a look at what they need to do on offense here, because since that opening drive of 72 yards, they've only gained 22 since. So the offense, we've said it, is lacking just a bit. Again, that's...
Well, and credit to Independence.
They've
controlled both the defensive and offensive lines tonight in this first half, and that's where it all starts. So
Yeah, absolutely, Jamie. The Hawks are going to have to go in and do
Hawks
some self-evaluation.
Hawks have got a hurry here as the play clock down to 5 seconds as they come set. One more play left in this first half. A low snap to Ridenour. He fields it, but Mustangs are going to call a timeout.
They're going to have to reset the clock then, too, I think. Yeah, Coach Wink is now pointing at it.
So they're down to 2 seconds on the game clock.
There were four left, though, when it started, yeah.
Was it four seconds?
Yeah, 4.4, I think. Yep, officials calling for
4 seconds. Not 40. Well, we'd take 44. We would take
Throwing
that.
A couple timeouts. We'll,
there it is, 4.4. That's what they wanted. As the Mustangs, again, like you said, you know, the Hawk offense hasn't been able to move the ball, but you got to give credit to that Independence defense because they have controlled things up front. They have gotten through that Hawk offensive line. And really, both teams fortunate. They've been playing good defense because neither offense, really, Independence has had some big plays but haven't been able to finish drives here. So both teams fortunate this game is as close as it is. Ridenour looks to throw. Last play of the first half, he steps up, and he's going to get dropped right at midfield. Matt McMillan sacks Ridenour in the backfield, and that will do it for quarter number two. As it's 9-6, Independence leads here. We'll come back for halftime. We'll talk to Bob Morris. We'll talk to our honorary captain, Jim Wickman. We'll go through some scores and talk about our Hawks in the NCAAs. Right after this, you're listening to West Delaware football here on Eastern Iowa Sports Station, Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Farmers Savings Bank proudly supports all area athletes and their coaching staff. For all your banking needs, visit them in Colesburg, Elkport Garber, Strawberry Point, Arlington, and Aurora, or online at farmerssavingsbank.com. Member FDIC.
Biofield is your headquarters for all your seed, chemical, and fertilizer needs. They have professional service and quality products needed to bring the best crop to market. Biofield, providing growth opportunity for 18 locations across northern Iowa and southern Minnesota.
Looking for great food, friendly service, and a unique atmosphere? Then plan your next lunch or dinner at Okoboji Grill in Independence, 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet.
The Eastern Iowa Shopping News and the Dyersville Commercial recognize the hard work and dedication of all area athletes. Check out the weekly sports section in the commercial for scores and information. The Eastern Iowa Shopping News and Dyersville Commercial, supporting your communities.
Do you suffer from chronic or acute pain? Long-Term Medical Supply now offers pain relief for you with their non-prescription TENS device. Shop their convenient location in downtown Manchester and find pain relief in as little as 15 minutes with a TENS device from Long-Term Medical Supply.
And welcome back into halftime. Jamie Vasky back along with you as we've got the Hawks and the Mustangs going at it here in week number 8 action. And joining me is West Delaware freshman head coach Bob Morris. As coach, you've put us fans in some really exciting finishes here so far this season. And it continued here again tonight, a 22-20 victory. And in that fourth quarter, it was lead change after lead change, but you guys came away and a very good win by your kids here tonight.
Well, thank you, Jamie. We're real proud of the kids hanging in there. You know, you would love to have the games come out where you just get control, and those games are fun. But these are the kind of games that they're going to be in the majority of the time. And you just got to hang in there when things go bad. The kids do a great job of that, of believing in what we're doing and believing in each other. And they came out there and fought the second half. We had a couple injuries with our quarterback, and he couldn't throw the ball as well as he wanted, so we had to rely on that offensive line and the legs of Caleb Curley and Jordan Brees. And they really run the ball well that second half and kind of kept us in the game.
Yeah, 335 rushing yards on the night for you guys and a total of 346. And I think heading into that second half, you guys had to have had the momentum and the kids had to have been feeling good because Independence got it first and goal on like the 3-yard line or right down inside the 5. And you stopped them 4 plays in a row and a big defensive stand before halftime.
Boy, that was a big stop there, and we sold that to the kids. That, you know, you won the game right there, and we just go out and take care of business in the second half.
And I think that stopped there. And, of course, my daughter's middle school band playing at halftime. And I think that all motivated us to do a great job. And it was nice to see those young kids out there. And then back to the football, the kids came out with the momentum that we had on that stop and carried that over into the second half and running the football and doing what we needed to do.
Well, you mentioned Caleb Curley, 262 yards on the ground tonight. You make your raise your record to 5-2 now with 1 week left to go next week up in Decorah. And just, you got to be happy with the effort of these kids and what they've done all season long, because, you know, you could tell at the beginning of the season that they were freshman football players playing high school ball for the first time, and they've really come along and developed really well this season for you.
Well, they're certainly growing, and, you know, certain football teams have an identity, and that was with Nick Casey, our quarterback, and Derek Krogman, and they kind of went with the sophomores, so we had to find a new identity with the team, and that took a little while, those first couple games, and then just working on things in practice. And now getting more comfortable with the system and what we're trying to do. They do a great job in practice, and I want to take another opportunity to thank the sophomore coaching staff. We do a lot of things together with them, and we share a few of our players other than those two that I mentioned. And just continue to grow, and I think you're really seeing that in the varsity the next couple of years with our kids, the freshmen, moving up to sophomores, and then moving into the varsity, some of the younger guys, and really got a good thing going here.
Absolutely. Well, Coach, congratulations on the win tonight, 22-20. One more week next week up at Decorah. Thanks for joining us this season and joining us here again tonight.
All right. Well, thanks, Jamie. We'll be ready to go at Decorah. That's a chance for us to get the district title. And if we can beat Decorah, they'll always have a good team. And up there, just a great challenge and test for the kids. So win or lose, it'll be great for the kids to be in that environment.
All right. West Delaware freshman coach Bob Morris here at halftime. We'll be back with our honorary captain this week, Jim Wickman, right after this. You're listening to West Delaware Football from KMCH Sports.
Whatever your favorite sport, we know you will join Parrot Insurance and Grinnell Mutual in supporting all of our local athletes. Parrot Insurance is proud to be part of this community and looks forward to catching all of the sports action this year. If you want a strong insurance team working for you, call Parrot Insurance today for a quote from Grinnell Mutual and experience our policy of working together.
For fan food, not fast food, visit your after-the-game headquarters, Manchester Dairy Queen. It's quick, it's easy, your family will love it. Manchester Dairy Queen.
Jamie Baskin back along with you. Hawks and Mustangs, week number 8 of the 2015 high school football season. And joining me right now is our honorary captain for tonight's game, Jim Wickman, a 1966 graduate of West Delaware High School. And Jim, you got to lead the Hawks out there before the game for the coin toss as the honorary captain. How did it feel to be asked by Coach Wink to be an honorary captain here tonight?
It kind of really surprised me by a long ways. I wasn't expecting that at all.
You've been a part of the West Delaware program for quite some time as you've lived in the Manchester area. For 43 years, you've been cutting hair here in Manchester for about 45 years, you and your wife, Shirley, also a West Delaware graduate, been in the Manchester area for a long time. You've been on the chain gang for 15 years, but you've seen more West Delaware games than that as you make it a point to travel to those games. So you have, in your time, have seen some great West Delaware football.
Yeah, I haven't missed a home or away game for over 30 years and seen a lot of good kids come through and a lot of good coaches come through, and we're happy with most of the outcomes of everything.
Well, you, in those 30 years that you mentioned, seeing all those games, you've seen a lot of firsts. You know, the first time the Hawks made the playoffs and the first state title, the only state title that the Hawks had. How have things changed since you started first going to West Delaware football games?
Well, they've changed a lot. I think our coaching staffs have gotten a lot better. They go into detail with the kids a lot more, and our kids maybe listen to them a little bit better than some years past.
Well, you another thing that you, being on the chain gang for the last 15 years, you get to kind of see things from the opposing team's side, and you're going to see that tonight here with the Independence Mustangs. Is this one of the biggest games you've seen here on Brown Field in a while?
It's one of the biggest games we've seen in the last 10 years up here, I believe. It's kind of fun to see on the side over there, listening to the opposing coaches, the opposing players about the some some of the ways the refereeing is going against them. And it's kind of fun just to listen to and not say anything.
Absolutely. Well, we like to put pressure on the honorary captain to get a win, so hopefully the Hawks can do that here tonight. And, Jim, thanks for joining us here at halftime, and get back to the sideline there and get things underway.
Thanks, Jamie. Enjoyed it.
All right. Jim Wickman, our honorary captain here tonight for Week 8. We'll be back with more with the Hawks and the Mustangs right after this on Mix 94.7 KMCH.
It's no secret that people come to Fairway in Manchester for their famous meats, but as you dash back to the counter to pick up your USDA Choice ribeyes, don't be surprised if you find yourself lingering among the delicious fruits and vegetables in the produce department.
All right.
Shop Fairway in Manchester for low prices and all your grocery needs.
Cy and Charlie's in Independence sell the full line of top-quality Whirlpool appliances, including Maytag and KitchenAid, at competitive prices. Cy and Charlie's offers professional delivery, installation, and factory-trained service. Best of luck to the Independence Mustangs from Cy and Charlie's, your Whirlpool, Maytag, and KitchenAid headquarters in Independence.
Back in the Brown Field, Mustangs lead the Hawks 9-6 as we near quarter number three. We take a look at our NCAA schedule for tomorrow and our Hawks in the NCAA segment. Last week, the Hawkeyes defeated Illinois on homecoming in Iowa City 29-20. John Swisher was victorious in that week. So our standings currently, Bill Logan has four wins. John Swisher has two. Aaron and I are still in the cellar with zero. We're going to get over that this week as the Hawkeyes take on Northwestern in Evanston tomorrow, an 11 o'clock kick between the Hawks and the Wildcats. The Iowa State Cyclones lost last week 66-31 to Texas Tech, and they are now 2-3 overall. They will host TCU at 6 o'clock tomorrow in Ames at Jack Trice Stadium. UNI Panthers fall to 2-3 after a heartbreaking loss to North Dakota State in Fargo last weekend, 31-28 the final. Adam Reth had eight total tackles in that game. Had eight total tackles, 29 total on the season, with one and a half of those tackles for loss, as they will host Western Illinois tomorrow at 4 o'clock in the Unidome, homecoming week for Iowa or UNI tomorrow. Upper Iowa got back on the winning track last week as they defeated Concordia University of St. Paul's at home last week, raised their record to 4-2 now, does Upper Iowa. They will travel to Winona tomorrow and take on Winona State University as Trey McTaggart, Cole Steven, Cameron McCrow, and Brent Lammers, all graduates of West Delaware, playing for Upper Iowa. McTaggart in that game last week had seven receptions for 112 yards. On the season now, he has 32 receptions for 438 yards and one touchdown. Cole Stevens, six total tackles in that game, one tackle for loss. On the season now, has 50 total tackles, 6.5 tackles for loss. Wartburg and Cole last weekend up in Waverly, as we had Brandon Domeyer and Michael Bulkey playing for Wartburg, Sam Lahr playing for Coe College, and Wartburg wins that game 31-14. To raise their record to 5-0 as they will take on the University of Dubuque tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Brandon Domeyer in that game, 17 carries for 98 yards and one touchdown. On the season now, Domeyer has 93 carries, 473 yards, and nine touchdowns. Michael Bulkey, 4-for-4 on extra points, and he kicked his career-long field goal as he was 1-for-1 on field goals. His career-long now of 35 yards, so Michael Bulkey now 20-of-21 extra points, and 2-for-4 on field goals on the season. Also threw a pass as a bad snap on the he had to run the old fire drill and threw an incomplete pass in that game last week. So Michael Bulkey getting in the throwing column for the Wartburg Knights. Sam Lahr in that game for Combe had seven carries for 20 yards. On the season now has 85 carries for 450 yards and two touchdowns. Sam Lahr and the Cohawks will have homecoming tomorrow in Cedar Rapids as they take on Simpson College. Co is now 2-3 on the year. And that is a look at our Hawks in the NCAA segment, as get some updated scores here. After three quarters. Edco trails Lisbon 35-0. Late in the second quarter, it was 35-6. East Buchanan leading North Wind. That was late in quarter number two as we hit the refresh button here on the KMCH.com scoreboard. If you're at home and want to take a look at other scores, take a look at that as Charles City leads Decorah 30-7 or 20-7. That game is at halftime. Waverly Shell Rock over Crestwood at halftime 14-6. Solon leading Western Dubuque 28-7 at the half. Beckman and New Hampton tied at 7 at halftime. As Anamosa leading Union 21-0 at the half. Monticello leading Tipton 17-13. That was a second quarter score. And as we mentioned, East Buchanan leading North Wind 35-6. That was a second quarter score as well. As we mentioned, Cascade is at Mount Vernon tonight. Don't have a score of that one right now, but that is a look at our scoreboard here on this Friday night. The Hawks have not returned from the locker room yet, as they're going to just take advantage of the 3 minutes that they're allowed when the halftime clock expires. Here come the Hawks as they're back onto the field. We'll talk to Bill Logan when he gets out here as he's making his way up the sideline as well. But these two teams at the top of Class 3, District Number 3, over in District Number 4, Western Dubuque is 1-3. If they could pull off a win tonight in Solon, I think one more could get them into the playoffs as they're 1-3. Xavier leads that District 5-0. They're taking on Iowa City Regina tonight, a great matchup down there. Maquoketa 4-1, Solon 2-2, Wallert of Dubuque Wallert 2-2 as well. Class 2A, District Number 3, Beckman is 3-1 in district play. North Fayette also 3-1 in district, as is New Hampton and Waukon. A tight district there, four teams at the top with all having the same record. Center pointer Banna is 2-2, and they're taking on Waukon tonight. Oline is 1-4, and Waterloo Columbus is 0-5. Class 2A District 4, Anamosa on top there, 5-0. Mount Vernon, Tipton, and Cascade are all 3-1 in the district. Monticello's 1-3. Northeast Goose Lake is 0-4, and Comanche is 0-5. And in Class A, District Number 5, Maquoketa Valley on top with a 5-0 district record. Lisbon and North Wind tied at 4-1. Easton Valley is 3-2, as is East Buchanan. Edco is 1-4. Starmont is 0-5, along with Postville. Bill Logan is back on the sideline, and Bill, a defensive battle there in the first half. As you mentioned to us in the one break, that the Hawks had 72 yards on that first drive, only picked up 22 after that, and that first drive was the very first drive of our ball game. So the Hawks, since the 8:34 mark in the first quarter, have only accumulated 22 yards.
Yeah, the game that I kind of thought maybe coming in, I didn't know if either defense could stop the other team's offense, but we've seen that the defenses are just taking control tonight. And outside of three big plays that Indy's come up with, it's been that defensive battle that I wasn't anticipating. For Independence, they rushed about 22 times for 150 yards. Holt with 134 of those on 18 carries, and he got two carries for 100 yards. So outside of that, he didn't do, Hawks contained him real well, except for twice. And one was that big 63-yard touchdown run. 6 out of 15 passing for 92 yards. So 242 yards of offense for Independence, a very productive half, but 150 of those on three plays. So the other plays less than 100 yards. So, they made some plays. So Hawks haven't done anything here yet after that first drive. 16 carries for 43 yards. 5 out of 14 passing for 49 yards, 92 yards. The Hawks offensively this year are averaging more than that per quarter. They're going to have to come out here, and they've made some adjustments. Hopefully some of these things work here in the third quarter. And I think momentum in this third quarter is going to be a big thing going into the fourth quarter.
Well, the Hawks have to kick off to the Mustangs. What's this? They got to be happy with the defensive side to the Hawks besides those big plays, don't they?
Absolutely, and they're talking, the way we played that first half, we're probably pretty fortunate to only be down 3.5. So, they get the ball first, so hopefully the defense can set the tone right away here get a possibly a three and out and get that good field position and get the Hawks going here in the third quarter.
Bill Logan down on the sideline is gives us our halftime stats. The Hawks will kick off. Kyle McGrain set to kick off for the Hawks. Deep to receive for the Mustangs. There's Drew Davis and Mason Wood. West Delaware senior night here tonight. As we'll take a look at the West Delaware seniors, Owen Ward, Aaron Demmer, Luke Murray, Sam Maloney, Kyle Curley, Sage Suter, Matt McMahon, Max Ridenour, Caleb Whitman, Brett Roush, Coy Russell, Reese Maurer, Ryan DeSoto, Eric Vasky, Bennett Cole, Noah Lindauer, Colin Weber, Spencer Barron, Blake Schrader, Colin Brown, Logan Mullen, and Kyle McGrain. As Drew Davis is going to return this kick for the Mustangs out to about the 26-yard line, and that's where the Mustangs will start with it, first and 10. Aaron, Hawks, it's pretty simple. The Hawks have got to play better on offense.
Well, I think it starts in the front, in the lines, Jamie. It starts on the offensive line. It's opening holes for Max Ridenour and Coy Russell. That will establish the passing game. So that's the big thing in this second half is can the offensive line establish and open some holes for the for Max and Coy, and if they can do that, I think, you know, you'll see the Hawks move the ball much better than they did in the first half.
First and 10, they give the Mustangs their own 27-yard line as Nicholas Holt comes set. Jake Jewell shotgun in next to him in the shotgun formation. Matt McMillan, the fullback, stands just behind left guard. He goes in motion. Holt looks to run. He gets held up, and now he finds room to run. He's up the sideline to the 42, 43-yard line before he's finally stopped. Brett Roush and Bennett Cole combine on the stop, and we're going to get a penalty from way back here. As that's going to be a late hit. As that play went a little longer than it should have, and I believe we're going to get a personal foul against the Hawks. Absolutely, and there it is, 15 yards.
Now, we talked about in the first half, you mentioned it, Jamie, you talked about keeping emotions in check and making sure no penalties that can come back and haunt you later on in the game. And right off the bat here in the second half, there's one against the Hawks. So it's going to be really important, someone to step up there, one of those 11 defenders, and say, hey, guys, let's keep everything in check here. Let's just go out and play football.
So from the 44 of Independence to the 41 of West Delaware, the Mustangs have it first and 10. Holt comes set. He's going to keep it himself up the middle, bounces off one, and Colin Weber is going to wrap him up as they come up and make the stop. A couple-yard gain there by Nicholas Holt. Holt and Bennett Cole comes up for the Hawks. Makes the stop. It's going to be a two-yard gain for Nicholas Holt. And bring up second down and 8 from the West Delaware 39. The Mustangs leading 9-6, 11 minutes left to go in the third quarter. As they come set, shotgun formation, Holt stands back. He looks to throw. He's going to pump fake. Now he's looking to the far sideline. He's got a man out there, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Spencer Pink. In and out of the hands of Pink, Sam Maloney. Great coverage out there by the Hawks, and it'll bring up third down and 8 for the Mustangs.
That's really good defense by Sam Maloney. You know, Sam's a 6'3 defensive back, so that ball would have to have been thrown absolutely perfect in order for Pink to catch it. So nice job by Sam to turn around and identify where the ball was and create a big third and 8 here for this Independence offense.
So third and 8 for the Mustangs. Nicholas Holt, shotgun formation. Again, McMillan, Matt McMillan, another senior. Three seniors in the backfield here for the Mustangs. Nicholas Holt rolls to his right. He's looking to throw. Under pressure, screen set up. McMillan's got it. There's a penalty marker down, and there's in the backfield. Penalty marker down. As that pass falls incomplete, it's holding against the Mustangs. I believe they're going to get Jake Jewell. They're going to get Jake Jewell for the hold as he was back there with McMillan. I believe, did McMillan come down with that? I don't think he did. I think the pass was incomplete.
Yeah. Yep.
As he was hit as he was going up to catch that ball. I think the Hawks, you got to back him up here. Third and fourth and 8, and they're in four down territory. As the Hawks, this is a big penalty. It's a spot foul.
Yep.
They were on the... they were on their own 38-yard, or the West Delaware 38-yard line. Now they're back at their own 42. So about where this drive, this, you know, the last set of downs was here for the Mustangs. It's going to be third down and 27 for Independence. as it's back at their own 43-yard line. Holt looks to pass. Looking down the field, he's got Hootsloff, and that's incomplete. Owen Ward was trailing him, and it'll bring up 4th and 27. Good decision there by that Hawk coaching staff. Is now a 4th and 27 for the Mustangs at their own 43.
And good recovery by that defense after the first down, plus the late hit. Put Independence in some pretty good business there on the West Delaware side of the field. So good job by that defense of kind of picking things up and pushing Independence back. And now they should get the ball with pretty decent field position, I would think.
So Holt looks to punt it away here for the Mustangs. As deep to receive is Owen Ward. He's going to call for a fair catch. He comes up and goes down to a knee to catch it. Back at his own 20. They're going to give him the 30-yard line. That's where the Hawks will start first and 10. So we'll see what kind of halftime adjustments the Hawks made here at halftime. Hawkeye fans, don't forget you can get 90 minutes of Hawk football talk with the voice of the Iowa Hawkeyes, Gary Dolphin, and Iowa head football coach Kirk Ferentz every Wednesday night at 6:30 right here on Mix 94.7. KMCH. Third quarter, 10-12 left to go. The Mustangs of Independence, ranked number 6 in the state, Class 3, lead the Hawks, who are ranked number 2, 9-6. The Hawks look to run on 1st and 10. The give is to Russell, and he might have picked up a couple there, but he's brought down out there by the Mustangs, Isaiah Miller. And he gets one. It'll bring up 2nd down and 9, just under 10 minutes remaining here in quarter number 3. Again, the Hawks have not been able to get the run game going here as they look to come here on 2nd down and 9. Reinauer looks to throw. He's got a man open. It's Maloney at the 43. Run out of bounds at the 49-yard line. That'll be good for a West Delaware first down. So they move the chains this time here and pick up a first down. They have it at their own 49-yard line.
You can see Independence putting a defender to try and undercut that throw, but Max did a nice job of throwing it over the defender's head right to Sam, and Sam did a good job of just turning it up the field, picking up some extra yardage. Hawks on the move now.
Right now, here comes Seth to give it to Russell off the left side. He bounces off of one, crosses midfield down to the Mustang 47-yard line. So that'll be a pickup of 4 yards there, and it'll bring up 2nd down and 6 here for the Hawks. So just got to keep gutting out those
grinding
yards,
yep,
if you're the West Delaware Hawks, because I think that's one thing that this Independence defense has not been on the field a whole lot here in this game.
No, they haven't. A lot of that is attributed to their offense, keeping it on the ground, and with Holt's running ability, they've done a good job of chewing up some clock.
2nd and 6 for the Hawks. The give is to Russell. He's got it up the middle. He crosses down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line, and it'll bring up 3rd down and 3 yards here for the Hawks as they need to get to the Mustang 41 for a first down.
Well, and you get 3rd and 3 versus what they've been getting the majority of the night, which is 3rd and 8, 3rd and 9, sometimes 3rd and 10. So this is at least a manageable 3rd down.
Reinauer looks to pass on 3rd and 3 as he's looking to the sideline looking for Maloney, and he overshoots Maloney as he couldn't come up with it on the sideline as Drew Davis was there on the coverage for the Mustangs. It'll bring up 4th down and 3 for the Hawks. 8:27 left to go, 3rd quarter, 9-6, Independence leading West Delaware. So the Hawks look like the Hawks will go for it here. As you hear the defense chant from the other side and the Independence Mustang cheering section, Reinauer is going to cut in behind Coy Russell. He's going to pick up enough for the first down. Spins out of one. Has it at the 30.
Going. Still going.
Down to the 20 is Max Reinauer. Still on his feet. You got to blow that dead as Max Reinauer all the way to the West Delaware or the Independence 20-yard line. Pickup of about 23 yards there on 4th down and 3 for the Hawks.
It's a simple snap, the direct snap right to Max, and he just did a good job of bringing it to the near sideline, cutting the corner, and then he had two or three defenders on him for about 15 yards and just did a good job of picking up the extra yardage.
1st and 10, Hawks from the Mustang 20. Right now he keeps himself. There's going to be a penalty. He's down near the 5 as the penalty marker came in around the 20-yard line. As we'll see what this is going to be.
to be holding against the Hawks. As they're going to say, one of the Hawk offensive players kind of came out for that block. I'm wondering if it was Coy Russell. He came out and looked like he got his arms spread out, locked him up. So it's going to be first and long here for the Hawks, all the way back to the 30-yard line. So first and 20 here for the Hawks. They have it at the Independence 30. As they get the play call from Coach Winkiewicz. First down and 20 for the Hawks. 7:44 left to go. Third quarter. The Hawks throw a bubble screen out to Ward. He's got it at the 25. Go. Run out of bounds at about the 23-yard line as he's brought down out there by Elliott Ryan, the senior for the Mustangs. As the Hawks will face second down here as they mark this down at the 23-yard line. It'll be second down and 13 here for the Hawks. Ridenour comes set. Three receivers to the right. Nobody split out to the left. They're going to run to the left as Russell gets a block, hits a block for Ridenour. He gets it down inside the 20-yard line, back to around the original line of scrimmage, and it'll be third down here for the Hawks. As this is kind of what you were talking about earlier, Aaron, was those third and long situations. You like those third and threes, but now you're looking at a third and nine, and you're marching down the field. Is this going to be third down and nine for the Hawks from the Mustang 19? They're going to throw that bubble screen to Ward again. He's going to get it at down inside near about the 13-yard line is where he's going to be run down. Hawks might have got away with looked like maybe a hold down there, but no call. As Elliott Ryan comes up and makes a stop for the Mustangs.
And that's what you get when, you know, with penalties, that's what happens, is it puts you in really difficult situations. But fourth and three here for the Hawks. They converted on their last one. Hopefully they can duplicate that here this play.
The Hawks face fourth and three. Russell stands behind beside Max Ridenour. Ridenour is going to go out to the right side. He's got it at the 10, and I think that's all he's going to get. I don't think he got it. They're going to mark him down at the 11, and it'll be first and 10 Mustangs. So the Hawks turn it over on downs, and the Mustangs will take over first and 10. Couldn't get that push as the Hawks weren't really able to seal the edge there, and the Mustangs got out there on that defensive side, and they couldn't pick up enough for the first down. It'll be first and 10 Mustangs at their own 11-yard line. So see what the Mustang offense has here with 6:31 remaining in the third quarter, and they lead it 9-6. Holt comes set, shotgun formation. He throws quickly to the right, bubble screen. He's got boot flop, spins out of one, gets it to about the 15-yard line before he's run down as Owen Ward comes up and makes the stop for the Hawks. Bennett Cole also there for West Delaware. So pickup of about 4 yards. Pick up about 5 yards there. It'll bring up second down and five here for the Mustangs. Ball at their own 16-yard line. As Holt comes set, shotgun formation. He's going to wait for the hole to open up. Now he hits it, and he's going to run off to the right side. He picks up a couple more near the 20-yard line. As coming up and making the stop is Eric Vasky. So it's going to be third down and three here for the Mustangs as they have it at their own 19-yard line. 5:35 remaining in quarter number three. Mustangs leading the Hawks 9-6. They're going to run to the left are the Mustangs, and Holt keeps it himself. He's going to pick up enough for the first down. He flips up right in front of Sam Maloney on the West Delaware sideline. He brings it out to around the 25-yard line, and that'll be good for a Mustang first down. So first and 10 Mustangs. Again, we'll pick two players of the games tonight, one from each team. As our sponsor for that, our player of the game sponsor tonight is Okoboji Grill, 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet. Our sponsor for our player of the game. We'll pick one from each team. Holt keeps it himself, fakes the reverse, trips over his own player, falls to the ground at about the 29-yard line. Pick up a four there. It'll bring up second down and six.
This is what we talk about. You know, you talked about Independence's defense not being on the field too much, Jamie. This is what that Independence offense does. You know, it just grinds out first downs, grinds out, chews up clock, and that's where, and that's why the defense hasn't been out there. So the Talk defense, hopefully, and the Talk defense has done a great job tonight. They need to step up here again and hopefully, you know, stop Independence this time around.
Second down, six for the Mustangs. Holt keeps it himself up the middle. Bennett Cole meets him there at the 30-yard line, drives him backwards. They're going to give him the 31. A pickup of three there, and it'll bring up third down and four here for the Mustangs. 4:30 left to go, third quarter. Mustangs still leading the Hawks 9-6. Again, like Bill said, we thought this would be a high-scoring game here, but it has been anything but that. It's been a defensive struggle here between the trenches here. Third down and four for the Mustangs. They have it at their own 31-yard line. They need to get to the West Delaware 35. Holt comes set. He rolls to his right. He looks to pass. Yeah. Goes downfield. Going to be knocked away as the Hawks deflect that one. And it'll bring up fourth down and four. It looks like the Mustangs will send out the punting team.
That's a big third down stop there for the Hawks. Exactly what they need. That big defensive line coming through in a big situation there. So Talk offense, Jamie. We talked about it. They had a good drive there that last possession. Just couldn't put any points on the board. So they should get the ball with pretty good field position here. So hopefully they can keep that momentum on the running with the running game.
Nicholas Holt set to punt away for the Mustangs. He punts it from his own 20-yard line. It's going to be taken at the 40 by Tanner Wessels, and Wessels is going to be dropped down. Hold on to the ball. If you're Tanner Wessels, they're going to give him about the 43-yard line. That's where the Hawks will start first and 10. Hey, West Delaware volleyball fans, don't miss next week's broadcast, as it's the WOMAC Championship Tournament, as the Hawks will start at 5 o'clock against Center Point Urbana. The winner of that one will face the winner of Mount Vernon and Clear Creek Amana. That's a 4 o'clock match, and that next game will be at 6:30. Final game of the day will be, if the Hawks continue to win, will be at 7:15. You can catch all that right here on KMCH with Sports Director John Swisher and Joan Salo. First and 10, West Delaware. They have it at their own 43. They fake the reverse. They fake the handoff to Russell. Reinauer keeps it himself. He's still pushing forward, and he's going to take it himself all the way down to the Mustang 43-yard line. So we switched fields there from 43 to 40, the 43. Reinauer picks up enough for the first down. First and 10 Hawks, again on the Mustang side of the field. And you can see Max Reinauer on that running game just pushing for those yards. He's really trying to do it himself here tonight as he comes set. Another first and 10. They send Owen Ward in motion. This time they give to Russell. He's got it at the 40. He's going to pick up three before he's brought down out there by Elliott Ryan. 9-6, Independence leads with 3:20 left to go in the third quarter. Another update here. East Buchanan leading Northwind 43-12 at halftime as the Buccaneers trying to get themselves into the playoffs, into that mix anyway. They're going to run Reinauer to the right side on second down and 7, and he's going to bring it down inside the 40 to about the 37-yard line. So the Hawks need to get to the 33-yard line, so he's going to be about 4 yards short. It'll be third and four here for the Hawks. As the Hawks come set, trips receivers to the right for the Hawks. As Reinauer awaits the snap, the give is to Coy Russell. He goes up the middle, and he's dropped at the 35-yard line, a pickup of two. He's going to be 2 yards short of the first down. And it'll bring up fourth and two. We'll see if the Hawks are probably – you got to go for it again here. You're in four-down territory at the Mustang 35.
And, you know, it's at this point of the game, Jamie, where you just got to look at your offensive line and be like, get us 2 yards. Get us 3 yards. Let's go. Just get that push. You know, they got to understand what this means. So hopefully this Hawk offensive line can create a hole here and pick up this first down.
Fourth and two. The Hawks failed their last time. They're going to run the reverse to Owen Ward. He's got enough for the first down. Still on his feet. 20. 15, 10, we're going to get a face mask, because Owen Ward is down on the field. He laid back, and now he's sitting up, but he is in pain as Sam Maloney calling for the training staff, and Josiah Polito is out there immediately, but it's going to be first and goal for the Hawks. There's going to be a penalty on the play. It looked like it was right around where it's going to be a face mask. It's going to be personal foul, face mask against the Mustangs. Against the Hawks? What? Other way. No way. They're calling it. Are they calling that against the Hawks?
What?
Oh, they are calling that against the Hawks. As Owen Ward walks off under his own power. So, personal foul, face mask against the offense. As Owen Ward with a big run, but it'll be first and 10 nonetheless for West Delaware at the Independence 25-yard line. I'm not sure about that call. We'll see if we can get an explanation at some point, but the Hawks will have first and 10. A minute 40 left to go, third quarter, 9-6. The Mustangs lead the Hawks. They give to Russell. Off the right side, he's going to be wrapped up immediately by Jake Jewell at about the 23-yard line. There's going to be a pickup of a couple there as the clock continues to tick away here. Minute and a half left to go in quarter number three. As Russell, they give him 2 yards there. It'll bring second down and 8. Minute 10 left to go now as the Hawks come set. They're going to run power formation. They're going to run Russell behind Colin Weber. He gets to the outside, has it at the 20, 15, avoids one tackler, but Drew Davis is going to bring him down just short of the first down. He got to the 15-yard line. The Hawks need to get to about the 14-yard line of Independence. Nice tackle, the open field tackle there by Drew Davis. Not many bring Coy Russell down in the open field, but he did. It'll bring up third down and 1 here for the Hawks.
And I just saw Jamie, looks like Owen Ward got popped up there and looks like he's okay, so that's a good sign for the Hawks.
The Hawks are going to run Ridenour off to the right side. He picks up enough for the first down. Colin Butzloff brings him down right around the 10-yard line. So it'll be first and 10, West Delaware. And they're going to have it at the Independence 12. So the Hawks moving the ball here for the first time. And their last drive, they moved the ball, but turned the ball over on downs. 20 seconds remain in quarter number three. They give it to Russell off the right side. He busts through. He's got it at the 5. Hold on to the ball, Coy. You got to blow the whistle. It's dead. As it's going to be Coy Russell is going to bring it down to the 5 of Independence. And that is going to do it for our third quarter. It's everything we hoped for here as number 2 ranked West Delaware and number 6 ranked Independence. The Mustangs lead the Hawks 9-6. You're listening to it, and we'll be back for the fourth quarter right after this on Eastern Iowa Sports Station, Mix 94.7 KMCH.
Head to Fireside Pub and Steakhouse before or after the game or anytime. Featuring steaks, seafood, pasta, sandwiches, and even fresh-made pizza. They say it's the best around. Visit them on the web at firesidemanchester.com for a full menu and special offers.
Stop at the Sweet Spot and enjoy soup and salad specials, including chili, plus a different soup every day. Come enjoy the outside seating, have some wine or beer, and view the only beautiful river view in Independence. The Sweet Spot, next to the bridge in downtown Independence. Winter hours are Tuesday through Saturday, 10 till 4, or by appointment.
Just like a great coach, State Farm agents like me, Julie Smith, can help you develop a game plan for your insurance needs. Whether it's car, home, life, health, or business insurance, I can dig into the playbook and help you find the affordable coverage you need. For all your insurance needs, call on a winning team, the Julie Smith State Farm Agency in Manchester.
Back into Brown Field along with in-studio producer, KMCH News Director Janelle Tucker, Jamie Vasky, Aaron Pleen, and the hustling Bill Logan down the sideline. He was totaling up his stats there, and now he's got to hustle. See, that's why he stays warm when we're up here freezing. It's going to be second down and 3 for the Hawks. They have it at the Mustang 5. They're going to play got blown up. Jake Jewell came flying in from the left side as Ridenour was trying to follow his blockers off to the right, and Jake Jewell sniffed that one out, and he drops Ridenour in the backfield. It'll be third down and 6 for the Hawks as they have it back at the Mustang 8-yard line. Great play there by Jake Jewell.
Yeah, very good anticipation by Jewell. He read that Ridenour was just going to hang on to it, and he just bursted through the line and dropped him for about a 3-yard loss.
Ridenour comes set. He looks to pass. He's going to the end zone. He's looking for Maloney. Maloney's up. The pass is deflected. Tipped away by Drew Davis. And it'll bring up fourth down and six here for the Hawks as the ball is on the eight-yard line. And we'll see what the Hawks do here.
You know, you got a 6'3 Sam Maloney being defended by a 5'8 Drew Davis. You'd like to see the ball off a little higher, maybe see Sam go up and try and get it at its highest point. But nonetheless, good play there by Davis. He played the ball and did a good job.
Certainly was. The Hawks face fourth and six. 11:22 left to go. Independence leads 9-6. Ridenour keeps it himself. He's got it at the five. He's pushing close to that first down marker. He's down inside the five. There's a penalty marker on the play. There's a penalty marker down here on the near side of the field. Now they're going to mark him down. I think the Hawks needed to get to the three. They've got it marked at the four. Be holding against the Hawks. I think the coaching staff, they're going to decline it. He didn't get the first down, so they'll decline that penalty and turn the ball over on downs. So the Mustangs will take over first and 10 at their own four-yard line. Great stand by that Mustang defense there as they take over now first and 10, and the Hawk defense trots back onto the field. As Nicholas Holt, senior quarterback, looks to lead the Mustangs down the field once again. He's got it. They mark it at their own three-yard line, just beyond where they start the extra point. As Holt keeps it himself, there's going to be a flag. Yep. As there was, I don't think they really got that, or did they stop it? I thought we had a legal procedure. Oh, there's the flag. Illegal procedure as someone on the right side of that Mustang defense moved. That's going to be half the distance to the goal, so it'll be back at about the one-and-a-half-yard line-ish. As it'll bring up first down and 12 here for the Mustangs. As Holt comes set, shotgun formation. Next to him is Jewel. The fullback is McMillan. Holt takes the snap. He quick throw out to the left, and it's going to be caught by Butzloff, and he had to go down to the ground to catch that ball. So I think it might have got a yard out of that, as there's 11 minutes remaining here in this ball game. Independence still leading West Delaware 9-6. It'll be second down and 11 here for the Mustangs.
And defense for the Hawks right here. Again, another opportunity to create some, hopefully. And
as Holt comes set with 10:40 left to go in this ballgame. Holt's going to run it himself up the middle. Bennett Cole comes over and traps him down at the 5-yard line. And it'll bring up third down at about 7 yards here for the Mustangs. So, again, just what a great game. And this crowd that capacity crowd here at Brown Field has got to witness here tonight, and you've got two top 10 ranked teams going at it here in week number 8. Third and 6 for the Mustangs, they call it. Holt comes set. He fumbles it. Ball's on the ground. He's got a run. Throws it out. Incomplete pass.
Oh.
As it goes incomplete, as he fumbled it in the end zone, had to pick it up quickly, threw it out, trying to hit Butzloff. And it falls incomplete, and it'll bring up fourth down and 6. A lucky break there for the Mustangs.
Big time. Just kind of the snap just went through Holt's hands, and he fortunately bounced right back into him. But that could have been disaster for Independence. Nonetheless, the Hawks forced the fourth down, fourth and 6. They should get really good field position, we would hope. And who knows what can happen.
Fourth and 6 for the Mustangs as Holt awaits the snap to punt it away. 2 seconds on the play clock, and they're not going to get it. Did they get it off? They just got it off. As Holt's punt is away, it's a short kick. Yep. Owen Ward is going to call for a fair catch.
That's good.
Excuse me, that's Tanner Wessels on the fair catch. And the Hawks will take over first and 10 at the Mustang 35-yard line. So great field position here for the Hawks. They have not been able to put a drive away since the 8:34 mark in quarter number 1, where they scored their only touchdown to go up 6-0 on the first drive of the game. Since then, the Mustangs tied it,
They tied it, and then they kicked a go-ahead field goal back in quarter number two.
Yep.
As the Hawks will come set. First and 10. Ridenour going to run to the right. A nice block there by Coy Russell in the backfield. Ridenour's got it down near the 31-yard line. About a pickup of four there with 9:50 left to go in this ballgame. What a game, Aaron.
Yeah.
This is exciting.
Yeah.
This is real exciting.
A lot of people wouldn't think, you know, a 9-6 ball game would be exciting. People want to see offense, but it's really, you know, it shows how good these teams are, how well-rounded both teams are by these displays of defense.
And we've got to pick two players of the game individually. Right now it's looking like it's going to be two quarterbacks as Coy Russell's going to take the handoff. He gets down inside the 30. Might have got a couple yards. They'll bring up third down in about four. And our player of the game sponsor tonight is the Okoboji Grill, 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet. Our player of the game sponsor. We'll pick one from each team here tonight between the Hawks and the Mustangs as it's 9-6. Independence still leading. Third down and five upcoming for the Hawks. 8:55 left to go in the ballgame. Ridenour looks to pass. He can't find anybody open. Now he's going to throw down the middle, and it's going to be tipped away as it's looking for Owen Ward as Nick Holt comes across and knocks that ball down, and it'll bring up fourth down and five for the Hawks.
And Max had plenty of time back there. He just couldn't find anybody open, and Owen was open. If the ball was thrown just a little lower, I think he might have had it, but brings up another critical fourth down here for the West Delaware Hawks.
Fourth and five. Ridenour looks to pass. Now he's going to tuck it. Quarterback draw. He runs forward. And he flipped it. I think he tried doing too much with it there as he tried to flip the pitch the ball, and he threw it right into the hands of Nicholas Holt as there's a penalty marker on the field. Penalty marker on the field is going to be holding against the Hawks. They'll decline that and take over on the fumble as shades of last season for the Hawks. As last year we saw a ball get popped out right into the hands of Nicholas Holt. He ran it for a touchdown. This time, Ridenour, I think he was trying to flip it backwards, is what it looked like from up here. And it ends up in the hands of Nicholas Holt. And the Mustangs will take over first and 10 from their own 28-yard line as Holt comes set. First and 10. He's going to run it off to the right side. He's trying to get out to, now he's going to get to the outside. He's got it at the 35. Steps out of bounds. Is running him out of bounds over there in the Hawk sideline was Matt McMahon. And it's going to be good for a Mustang first down. With 8.5 minutes left to go in quarter number four, and the Mustangs leading 9-6, they have it first and 10 from their own 39.
And, you know, you've asked a lot out of this Hawk defense tonight, and they've always, you know, they've held up their end of the bargain pretty much this whole night. So, you know, you just hope this last 8 minutes and 30 seconds they can continue to keep doing what they've done all night and hope for a break.
So Holt comes set. I think the Mustangs want a timeout, and they take one with 8:30 left to go in the fourth quarter. We'll take one with them and come right back. You're listening to West Delaware Football from KMCH Sports.
Winthrop Veterinary Clinic is proud to support the Independence Mustangs team and coaches and wish them continued success. If you need veterinary skills for large animals or smaller pets, call the Winthrop Veterinary Clinic and ask Jim where he really likes the number 30.
Hi, this is Chris Henry, Service Manager of Brown Sales and Leasing in Elkader. Our goal is to make your car buying experience the best possible, and our factory certified technicians are dedicated to you and your vehicles. Stop in and see us at Brown Sales and Leasing in Elkader or visit us online at 4browns.com, your hometown dealer, wherever your hometown may be. Best of luck to all area athletes and coaches.
Fairway and Independence applauds the Independence Mustangs teams, coaches, and fans and wishes them continued success. Fairway, treating customers like family. Always fresh, always affordable, always Fairway and Independence.
At Three Rivers, our customers come first. Your business is very important to us. Our goal is to provide you with the best products and service that you have come to expect from Three Rivers. Visit our website at threeriversfs.com or the location nearest you. Three Rivers, your partner in growth solutions.
Back into Brown field. Nicholas Holt takes a first and 10 carry, and he's still on his feet. He's tough to tackle. He's got it at the 41. That'll be a pickup of two. Coming up and making the stop for the Hawks was Bennett Cole, as it's going to be second down. Well, they gave him the 43-yard line almost as a pickup of three, second and seven. Again, the Mustangs lead 9-6, 8 minutes remaining in the ballgame. As Nick Holt comes set, shotgun formation. As he takes the snap here, as he's going to let that play clock run down. He's going to run it up the middle, and he's going to be dropped as he hurtled through the middle of that pile. And Bennett Cole and Brett Roush combine on the stop there.
That's a dangerous play if you're an Independence Mustang fan. He left his feet there. You know, somebody punches that ball loose or something. That's a turnover. So
third and two here for the Mustangs. 7.5 remaining in the ballgame. Holt makes the call at the line, now heads back, shotgun formation. As he takes the snap, he's going to keep it himself. Off to the left side, he's going to pick up enough for the first down, right about the 49-yard line.
Flag.
There's a penalty marker down on the field.
Holding.
It is going to be a holding against the Mustangs. So that's going to back them up as the first down run by Nicholas Holt is going to be negated there. And it's going to back the Mustangs up. Do have another score update. Waverly Shellrock leads Crestwood 21-6 with 3 minutes and 53 seconds left to go in that ballgame. Here in Manchester, the Mustangs of Independence lead the Hawks 9-6. 7 minutes left to go in the ballgame. We've got a third down and 11 here for Independence. They have it back at their own 39-yard line. Again, trying to eat the clock here. The clock is very important now for both teams. The Mustangs trying to get out of here with a win. They're going to throw downfield. Got a man. It's going to be intercepted. Intercepted by Owen Ward as Nicholas Holt was looking for Colin Bootsloff, and Owen Ward makes the interception at the West Delaware 39-yard line with 6:47 left to go in the ball game. We just said it. Somebody had to make a play for the Hawks, and this time it was Owen Ward.
Yeah, and a big, nice play there by Owen. He followed the receiver down the field. The ball was thrown just a little short. Owen did a nice job of going up and getting it and giving this offense a chance now. You just feel like that at some point, if they keep grinding, there's something good is going to happen. You hope, you know, they've got 6 minutes and 47 seconds to get that done.
Pistol formation here for the Hawks. They're going to run to Russell. He slipped up, a little delayed, but he's going to get it at about to get up to the 40-yard line. That'll be a pickup of two there for Russell. It'll bring up second down. They're just going to give him one there, just shy of the 40-yard line. So second down and 9. So really gut check time for both of these teams. If you're the Mustangs, defense, what are you going to do here? If you're the Hawks, you just got a big play from your defense. What are you going to do with the ball? They send Russell in motion. As the play is a snap, Reidenauer wasn't ready for it. He's going to throw it downfield. Receiver slipped. As he was looking for Owen Ward, he slipped up running across the field as Reidenauer was under pressure, had to get rid of it, and it'll bring up third down and 9.
I noticed Max came back out. His ankles are all taped up and with some fresh tape there, so I don't know if his ankles are bothering him or what happened, but you can tell he's not moving. He doesn't have the shiftiness that he had in the first half.
So third down and 9 upcoming for the Hawks as they're running out of opportunities here on offense as there's 6:11 left to go and they trail by 3. Pressure's coming. Reidenauer looks to throw. Throws downfield, overshoots everybody as the closest man to it was Nicholas Holt as he was looking for Tyler Kelly down the middle of the field and it falls incomplete and it'll bring up fourth down and 9. Now the Hawks have a decision to make.
Are you
going to trust your defense here and punt this ball away? Are you going to try to go for it here because you're back at your own 40-yard line?
Now you got 6 minutes to go, and the Hawks have all 3 timeouts left, so you got to figure.
They're going to punt.
Yep.
Reidenauer stands back at his own 30. See if he can punt it away with,
they
like
got
you
no
said,
one back,
bet,
so that
they didn't
help.
Send anybody back. It's going to bounce, see if the Hawks can get to it. Chasing it is Maloney, and it deadens for him at the 3-yard line. right at the 3-yard line. Sam Maloney picks that ball up at the 3-yard line, and that's where the Mustangs will start, first and 10, with 5:51 left to go in this ball game, and the Mustangs leading 9-6. What a game this has been between two highly ranked opponents in Class 3A, both undefeated, both perfect in district play so far. The Mustangs win tonight, they will be district champs. As Holt comes set on first and 10, he runs up the middle, and he's going to be stuffed after a short gain as going out there and making the stop for West Delaware was John Nagel. They're going to give Holt a pickup of 1, so it'll be second down and 9 for Independence from their own 4-yard line. 5.5 left to go in this fourth quarter. Again, the Mustangs next week, they will be host Maquoketa for their last game of the year, non-district. The Hawks will travel to Decorah to take on the Vikings, who have one district loss on the year. As Holt will run it, he runs to the right side, and he's wrapped up, ran into a wall of Hawk defenders there. As Bennett Cole, Colin Weber combine on the stop there. As Bennett Cole helps Holt back to his feet there, as it'll bring up no gain on that play, as it'll be third down and 9 here for the Mustangs. Ball still at their own 4-yard line. See what they do here. The last time on third and long, third down, they threw it. It was intercepted by Owen Ward. See what the Mustangs do here. 9 seconds on the play clock, 4.5 left on the game clock. The snap, Holt looks to throw, throws it to the sideline. He overshot, looking for Bootsloff on the sideline. Owen Ward was there, but he threw it well out of bounds. And the Mustangs will face a 4th and 9, and they send out the punt team. And again, another good stand by this Hawk defense. So Holt will be punting from inside his own end zone, deep to receive for the Hawks, Tanner Wessels and Owen Ward. As Holt about 8 yards deep into the end zone as he awaits the snap. The snap is good. He's got it. And the punt is away. Owen Ward will take it at his own 40, or at the Mustang 40-yard line. Now he's running. It's going to be a block in the back. You hate that situation when a player comes back, when a player runs around like that.
Yeah.
You're going to see a penalty. And the Hawks, Owen Ward returned it all the way down to the Mustang 15-yard line, but it's going to come back. It's going to be holding against the Hawks. Hate to see that. Going to give up real good field position. You're still going to have it.
Should still have it on the Independent side of the field.
But this offense is going to have to move the ball if you're West Delaware, if you want to win this game, because you've got 4 minutes and 19 seconds remaining here, and you trail by 3. The Mustangs lead 9-6. What a game this has been. I tell you what.
It's been fast. This is one of the faster games, West Delaware's, in terms of time-wise.
20 minutes, now 23 minutes to 10 here. The Hawks will face first and 10 now. They're going to mark this ball after the penalty at the Independence 48. As the Hawks are going to run Ridenour off the left side. He's going to push forward. Hold on to it if you're Max Ridenour, as he's down around the 42-yard line of Independence. He's going to pick up about 6 yards there and bring up second down and about 4 here. Again, don't forget, right after our game here tonight, join Kevin Shookman and Dan McClain for our area online and playback game of the week. It's tonight, Western Dubuque is at Solon to take on the Spartans. Hawks come set. They give it to Russell on second down, and he's got room at the 30. Corey Russell has room, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, West Delaware. Corey Russell from 43 yards out puts the Hawks up 12-9 with 3:41 left to go in this ball game.
And what did we say? Keep grinding it out. Eventually good things are going to happen. And Coy Russell finally breaks loose. You knew an All-State running back wasn't going to be held down the whole time. So Great job there by that offense of coming through exactly when the Hawks need it. Big extra point right here.
Aaron Toll on for the extra point. The kick is up and it's through. West Delaware leads it 13-9. 3:41 left to go in the ball game. We will take a break and come back. You're listening to West Delaware football from KMCH Sports.
Are you looking for great food in a unique atmosphere? Then make Okoboji Grill your next lunch or dinner destination. That's Okoboji Grill, 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet.
Citizen State Bank, your locally owned, community-minded, and customer-oriented bank, is here to serve you. Choose one of their seven convenient locations in Winthrop, Monticello, Manchester, Ryan, Strawberry Point, Hopkinton, and New Vienna. Citizen State Bank, community banking with people you know, member FDIC.
Wapsie Valley Creamery in Independence is a family-owned business dedicated to serving family-owned dairy farms in Northeast Iowa, Northwest Illinois, and Southwest Wisconsin since 1906. Wapsie Valley Creamery Incorporated in Independence, partners in excellence.
Hard to hear on our sideline right now with the Hawks scoring that touchdown, a 43-yard Coy Russell touchdown as the Hawks go up 13-9 with 3:41 left to go in this ball game. Jamie Vasky, Aaron Pleen, and Bill Logan back with you. Kyle McGrain's kick is right at Matt McMillan. He makes a great catch, and he's going to bring it out to the 35-yard line, and that's where the Mustangs will start first and 10.
And finally, we get to have a touchdown scoring recap. Coy Russell with the 43-yard touchdown run, two plays, 48 yards, took 51 seconds off the clock. With the extra point, the Hawks take the lead 13-9 with 3:33 to go in the fourth
period.
What
was our last scoring recap there, Aaron? That Independence field goal.
Yeah, and that was back at 5:20 to go in the second period.
Wow.
Yeah.
Been a while, but the Mustangs come out on offense with 3.5 to play. First and 10. Nicholas Holt is going to run to the left. They're going to keep doing what's been working. He's going to be wrapped up. As coming up and making the stop, Brett Roush grabbed a hold of the jersey and brought Nick Holt down in the backfield. Clock will run here.
Yep.
Again, the Mustangs used the timeout earlier in this quarter as they have two remaining with 3 minutes remaining in this ballgame. We will get to all of our area scores at the end of the conclusion of this game. We want to stay right here with the action as the Mustangs face second and 15 from their own 32. Nicholas Holt looks to pass on second and 15. He's going to throw it deep. He's looking for Stager. That's intercepted. Matt McMahon with the intercept. Oh, that's Max Reidenauer. Max Reidenauer playing defense and gets the interception for the Hawks at their own 45-yard line. And Coach Ryan King, you got to love what he's doing right now. He's telling him to take a breath.
Yep.
Slow down, because there's still plenty of time here. Still plenty of time. 2:50 remaining. The Hawks, after the Max Reidenauer interception, take over first and 10 at their own 45-yard line.
Yep.
Whoa. As if this game wasn't exciting enough. With the defensive battle that we've had going, the Hawks finally breaking through.
Yep.
The Hawks take over first and 10 from their own 45. 2:50 left to go. Reidenauer keeps it himself,
going
to be brought down. Lost a yard, might have lost a yard there. And the Mustangs will take a timeout. We will take one with them. Hawks lead 13-9. 2:45 left to go in the ballgame. You're listening to West Delaware football from KMCH Sports.
This is Jamie Vasky, the voice of the West Delaware Hawks, and I've had the chance to review the Good Neighbor Society's playbook, and I got to tell you, they are friends in your neighborhood, designing plays to get you home fast. If you need help getting back in the game, contact the Good Neighbor Society Rehab to Home team at 563-927-3907.
Crop Production Services in Winthrop, your complete package for chemicals, seed, fertilizer, agronomy, soil sampling, and custom applications. Make sure you trust the experts at CPS in Winthrop with you every step of the way.
Back into Brown Field along with in-studio producer, news director, Janelle Tucker, Jamie Vasky, Aaron Point, and Bill Logan back with you here Hawks face a second down and 11 after the one-yard loss. They give us to Russell. He tries to get to the outside. He bounces off of one, but that same defender comes up, Mason Wood. Russell tried his stiff arm, and Wood wraps him up, still grabbed a hold of him, came from behind and brought Russell down. That's going to be a loss of three there. It'll bring up third down and 13 for the Hawks from their own 42-yard line, 2:36, and the Mustangs burn their final timeout of the ball game. Great game. We've got finals from around the area while we've got this timeout. As Solon defeats Western Dubuque tonight, we'll see. We'll refresh our scoreboard here. Charles City leading Decorah 20-7 in the fourth quarter. Crestwood leading Waverly-Shellrock 21-6. That was in the fourth quarter. Solon defeats Western Dubuque tonight. I believe that was a final, 36-7. Yes, it was, 36-7. That's a final. Western Dubuque falls to Solon tonight as we'll get back to that scoreboard as the Hawks are out of the timeout of Independence. Third and 13, 2:36 remaining in this ballgame, and the Hawks lead 13-9. Ridenour rolls to his right. He looks to pass. He's going to run it. He's just going to run all the way, and he does a flip. That's coming up and making the stop was Elliot Ryan, and that's another one you mentioned when we saw Nicholas Holt leave his feet earlier. That's a scary one there as Ridenour did a complete somersault in the air, and now you can kind of see Ridenour holding his left, something on his left. I know he's been bothered by a left shoulder earlier in the year, but the Hawks are going to let the time run down before they punt it away. We're right at 2 minutes remaining in this ball game, and the Hawks lead 13-9. Again, now the Hawks will take a timeout before they punt. 1:51 left to go in the fourth quarter. As other scores, Beckman leading New Hampton 21-7. That game in the fourth quarter. Anamosa leading Union 21-0. That was a halftime score. Tipton leading Monticello 20-7. As Waverly Shellrock, that is a final tonight, defeats Crestwood 27-6. So Waverly Shellrock wins tonight 27-6 over Crestwood. Lisbon was leading Edco 42-0 in the fourth quarter. East Buchanan in the third quarter leading Northland 49-12. And Mount Vernon was leading Cascade 27-14 that game in the third quarter. Back here in Manchester, the Hawks lead the Mustangs 13-9 with 1:51 left to go. The Hawks will set and punt this thing away. The Mustangs with two guys back to receive this punt. One of them is Nicholas Holt as they're trying to put the ball in their playmaker's hands. And Buchloff is going to call for a fair catch at his own 21-yard line. 1:44 left to go in the ball game. Last chance here for the Mustangs as they have no timeout. Tipton leading Monticello 20-17. Tipton leads Monticello. 1:44 left to go here. We will do a full scoreboard recap after our game here tonight, as we'll get our scores from Bill Logan. We'll make our Hawkeye predictions for tomorrow. Send you on your way to that area online and playback game of the week. But a lot happening here is the Mustangs are not out of it yet. The Holt is going to throw, and that ball's deflected. As Kyle McGrain got up and swatted that ball away, it was like Holt was going up for a jump shot in basketball, and McGrain comes up and swats that one away. It'll bring up second down and 10. Mustangs have it at their own 22-yard line. 4 seconds tick off there as there's 1:40 remaining in the ballgame. As you see, Max Ridenour still in on defense for the Hawks. Again, we saw with the Mustangs sending Holt back to receive that punt. You want your playmakers on the field, and right now that's Max Ridenour and Nicholas Holt. As Holt looks for Spencer Pink on the far side, as right around the left, the far hash, he was looking for Pink. but Sam Maloney was right there on the coverage. It'll be third and 10 for the Mustang. Minute 36 left to go in this ball game, and the Hawks clinging to a four-point lead at 13-9. You're listening to us tonight on your radio dial, or you're listening on KMTH.com. We appreciate it because this has been a good one. Third down and 10 for the Mustangs. They have it at their own 22. Holt comes set. He looks to pass. He's under pressure. Oh. He gets rid of one tackler. Throws it, and it's knocked away as Caleb Sparks knocks that ball away as it was intended for Bootsloff as a kind of a
dangerous
throw by Nicholas Holt as he threw across his body trying to come back.
Yep.
And it gets knocked away. It's fourth and 10 for the Mustangs. A minute 28 left to go here in this contest.
This is what high school football is all about, Jamie. This
Mason Wood in the backfield. Jake Jewell is not in the ballgame. It is Mason Wood in the backfield for the Mustangs. Holt looks to throw. He throws downfield. He's got a man out there, and it's going to be caught. Spencer Pink right in front of Sam Maloney, and it's at their own 35-yard line, and that'll be good for an Independence first down. First and 10 Mustangs. The Mustang crowd over there is looking for something on the sideline. You hear them hollering over there. Clock should be running. Oh, they've got out of bounds.
Yep.
First and 10 Mustangs. Holt avoids one Hawk. Now he steps up, and he's going to be dropped. No, he's not. He's still fighting. The ball on the ground. Hawks got it. I think the Hawks got it. Who's going to come out of the pile with it? The Hawks have it. And it's Eric Vasky.
That guy always recovers.
Eric Vasky.
He does.
I believe that's his third fumble recovery on the season. And he comes up with a big one here. The Hawks will take over. It'll be first and 10. West Delaware from the Mustang 37-yard line. 1:11 left to go. The Mustangs cannot stop it here. The Hawks will come out in victory formation, and they will get away with a 13-9 victory over sixth-ranked Independence here tonight as the Hawks will win it. They'll take a couple knees to do so. But the fans rejoice here on the sideline. The players, a big sigh of relief down there on the sideline.
Yeah.
As Independence ruined their perfect season last year over in Independence with a 10-0 shutout at Lyle Linebaugh Field in Independence. But tonight, and Coach Wink said in his pregame, the Hawks weren't looking for revenge here tonight.
No.
The Hawks were looking to win a ball game.
Yep. Yep, last year was last year. This year is about focusing on this particular team and winning this particular game, and that's exactly what happened. So
they were just out here to beat it the next team in line.
Yeah.
And that's gonna do it. The Hawks are gonna win it here as the players come off the field. And a great effort by both teams.
I was just going to say, Jamie, this Independence football team is going to do really well in the playoffs. They came in and played the best that they could probably play tonight. And, they came up a little short. But like we were talking about in the beginning, both of these teams are having really good years, and they're going to continue to have really good years. And no one should have to hang their head after tonight's performance. This was probably one of the best high school football games I've seen maybe ever.
That is a great high school football game right there. As the Hawks win it 13-9, we'll come back and try to sort this thing out here. As the Hawks win 13-9 here on Brown Field. As we've still got to put two players of the game as well. Brought to you by Okoboji Bar and Grill in Independence. We'll do that when we come back as well. West Delaware wins it 13-9 here on Brown Field. We'll be back after this. You're listening to it right here on Mix 94.7. KMCH.
The Edgewood Reminder is proud to support all the area teams in athletic action and appreciates their efforts in the classroom and during sports. Check out all the sports photos in each week's issue of the Edgewood Reminder.
Adams Family Furniture in downtown Independence has over 43 years in the furniture business. You can shop for quality brand names like Lazy Boy, Broyhill, Chromecraft, Peters Revington, just to name a few. Shop Adams Family Furniture in downtown Independence with free delivery. They will never be undersold on light quality furniture.
TriVet Associates is a mixed animal veterinary clinic with offices in Farley, Dyersville, and Holy Cross. Our eight doctors serve the Dubuque, Manchester, Guttenberg, and Cascade areas and provide veterinary services to both large and small animals. For more information, find us on Facebook or visit our website, trivetinc.com.
Pets Allowed in Independence, proud to support all area athletes, coaches, and fans. Pets Allowed has been your pet's lodging, grooming, and training specialist for over 16 years. Contact Pets Allowed at 319-334-7387, 319-334-PETS in Independence.
Whether it's an orthopedic, sports, or occupational injury you are suffering from, Regional Medical Center Therapy Services has you covered. With a customized treatment program, Regional Medical Center Therapy Services can get you back on track in the active game of life. Regional Medical Center, excellence in healthcare, close to home.
Citizen State Bank is your locally owned, community-minded, and customer-oriented bank here to serve you. Choose one of the six convenient locations, including Monticello, Hopkinton, Manchester, Ryan, Strawberry Point, and Winthrop. Visit them at citizenstateonline.com. Community banking with people you know. Member FDIC.
At Tucky Motors, we believe in a gentler, simpler way of doing business. Check out our large selection of new and pre-owned vehicles, as well as a great incentive at TuckyMotors.com. If you're looking for a new, pre-owned vehicle or service on your current vehicle, come to Tucky Motors, Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram on 9th Street in Dyersville.
Looking for great food, friendly service, and a unique atmosphere? Then plan your next lunch or dinner at Okoboji Grill in Independence, 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet.
Leonard Muller Funeral Home and Crematory wishes all the best to the athletes and appreciates their hard work and scholastic efforts throughout the year. For personal, caring service, Leonard Muller Funeral Home and Crematory in Manchester, Edgewood, and Strawberry Point.
Back into Brown Field, and the fans not wanting to leave here as they just saw one heck of a high school football game here in week number 8. Number 2 West Delaware gets out with a win here tonight, 13-9 over 6-ranked Independence. And Aaron, these fans don't want it to be over. I think the parents do to the fact of how intense this game was. But I tell you what, it was a great football game.
Absolutely, and give credit to both teams. I mean, both teams struggled offensively tonight. Credit the defenses, but you know, it was just a great football team, great football game all the way around. Both teams came in extremely prepared, so credit goes to the coaches for getting these guys ready to go. And what can you say? I mean, the Hawks made a couple plays here in the second half that really propelled them to the 13-9 win. But you know, again, I'll say about Independence, that team is going to be really tough to be a really tough out in the playoffs here in a couple weeks.
And I'm going
to
tell you something. This might not be the only time we see that team. Bill Logan joins us from the sideline. Bill, that was a heck of a high school football game right there.
I tell you what, everything was cracked up to me. I just thought it was a little higher scoring, but that just shows you the effort of the defensive coaches and they put out here tonight that it was just awesome. I mean, you're just sitting there waiting the whole second half, the third quarter. The Hawks flipped the field. They got the momentum. You just felt they were one play away, and they were.
Absolutely. That's one happy Hawk right next to you right now as we bring in, as we get Coach Doug Winkiewicz hooked up down there, and Coach Wink joins us now. Coach, Bill and I both, we were saying throughout this game, we thought this would be a high-scoring affair. Never thought it'd be a 13-9 defensive. As well, you got us. I think he's got us now. Maybe as we'll try to get Coach Winkiewicz hooked up. We got him now. Coach, Bill said a couple times we thought this would be a high-scoring game. Never did we think it would be a 13-9 defensive battle. But that's what it was. That was a great high school football game that you guys were able to come away with a win.
I'm glad you guys enjoyed it because it put about 5 years of. I tell you, that was I'm just so proud of our defense. And when we needed that play, you know, we went inside there with Coy, and it was a struggle all night. You know, we didn't throw the ball as well as we wanted to tonight. They were packing the box up. But, boy, I got to give credit to our defense. They just did a fantastic job.
And we also said that's a great Independence football team right there. You know, you could see them again down the line, and they gave you everything that you could have wanted from them tonight.
You know, they've got one of the most talented kids that I've seen in a long time. That quarterback is very special. And, you know, they've got a tremendous defense. And, you know, I just tell you, just proud that we just stuck with it. You know, just keep going. We didn't have a lot. We had to find some things. But they just kind of stuck with the course here, and we got her done.
Well, now you got to go against another rival next week in Decorah, and another tough week of preparation for you guys. But you're one step closer to that number one goal, and that's a district title.
Yeah, how exciting. You know, we just talked about that before the game. I mean, this is exactly the atmosphere. This is why we work so hard, you know, to try to play for that district championship every year. I'm just so, so happy for these guys. They put in a lot of time.
Coach, congrats on the win. We'll see you next week in Decorah.
Thanks, guys.
West Delaware head coach Doug Winkiewicz here in the post game as the Hawks get out of here tonight, 13-9, as they move to 8-0 for the first time since the 2005 season, 5-0 in district play. Independence will finish with a 5-1 district record as they move to 7-1 overall. Their last game is against Maquoketa in a non-district game. Bill Logan, oh man, this one's going to take a while to digest, because that was a tough one to watch, and that get the blood pressure medicine out tonight, because it's going to take a while to calm down from that one.
Well, you know, what a great night for senior night.
Absolutely.
You know, you always talk about senior night. You know, these kids go out and make a memory. You know, oh, man, is this a memory for senior night? Woo! The first half, the Hawks had such a good drive. We haven't seen a drive like that in a long time. The Hawks have been big play guys most of the year, and they put together that 10-play drive right off the bat. Man, after that, it just was zero. You got to give Independence all the credit in the world. They just stopped the Hawks time after time, 5 in a row, or 3 and outs, and you know, Hawks couldn't find anything. But there in that third quarter, you could see the Hawks getting a little bit of momentum. They were getting field position. Every time they kind of changed possessions, the Hawks were getting a little better field position. And, you know, we were talking on the sideline here, you know, they're going to bust one play. You know, they're getting close. They're going to bust a play. You know, and thank goodness Coy did there in the fourth quarter. And, boy, did that change it around. And, man, hats off to that defense. Woo! 67 yards of offense in the second half for Independence, so that's a high-powered offense. So what a tremendous job by the defensive unit here tonight.
Well, I was going to say too, Bill, Jamie and I, and you heard us too, we were just like, keep grinding it out, keep working, eventually something was going to happen. And you were absolutely right that, you know, Coy bust that 43-yard run there in the fourth quarter, but, you know, they stuck to it. The persistence of this Hawk offense, you know, came through here in the third and fourth quarter. And yeah, what do you say about the defense? I mean, man, they were just really impressive tonight.
Oh, that just and they've done so well all year long. I mean, they did whatever they needed to do. They made the adjustments at halftime. You know, they talked a little bit about what they needed to do to, you know, make sure they didn't get hurt on big plays like they did in the first half. And, you know, hey, 67 yards in the second half. That's pretty good after giving up almost 250 in the first half. So, you know, just a tremendous job. And you know, man. That was a great part of that game. Wow.
Well, you always come in after the games and at halftime and talk about these big offensive numbers, and we don't talk about the defense as much as we probably do about the offense. But tonight the defense, I think, really probably carried the load tonight and it showed. So
well, they did. They came up with two interceptions and two fumble recoveries, and every one of them was huge.
Absolutely.
That's a big. Tell you what, Bill, that's a big family picture right down there with the Lammers family. They bring one, they bring a whole bunch of them, don't they?
They'll probably have to have panoramic view.
Yeah, they do. As Brent is actually listening to us tonight, as I've gotten a couple picture messages from him tonight, tuning into
it. You'd love this, Brent.
Yeah, he would have. As Bill, we talked off the air. We said we'd make this a three-person decision on two players of the game, brought to you by Okoboji Grill in Independence, and we talked off air, and you probably got to give it to the two quarterbacks, Nick Holt and Max Reidenauer.
Yeah, they're the two guys that just made things happen. Nick Holt is, you know, I've been saying all week, he's probably one of the best athletes in Northeast Iowa. You know, he's a good quarterback, but he's a talented athlete. Never comes off the field. You know, he's on the field all the time, and you can see he's their leader. And he made some good plays in that first half. The Hawks really did a good job of containing him in the second half.
Well, he really did. And actually, you know, he's for him to put up those numbers and continue to play at that level, not coming off the field the entire game is just outstanding. The stamina in him is outstanding as well, and he's going to show that on the wrestling mat in the wintertime, and he's just a great all-around athlete. For the Hawks, Max Ridenour, a great game by him once again, doing it on the in the air. He threw for the Hawks tonight and then scored that first touchdown. And in one of the biggest plays of that second half was the interception he made down here at the 45-yard line when the Mustangs were looking to make a drive late here.
He did, but he also got a couple big first down carries there in that third quarter that kept drives going. Not scoring drives, but kept drives going so that they could flip that field and get that field position. So, he got hit 3, 4, 5, 6 times, and he just didn't keep going down. He kept going, and it's just his drive and determination. He was not going to be denied. They were going to win this game tonight.
Well, that's going to do it for the high school portion of this broadcast here for just a little bit, as we've got to make our predictions for tomorrow's Hawkeye game. John Swisher victorious last week again, as that means it's still just between you and Swish, Bill, as Aaron and I.
Is there
still
anybody else playing? You guys want to play this week?
It certainly doesn't seem like it to this point, but we're definitely gonna try our best. Swish picked 21-18 for a final, and like we've always done, we go back if we take the winner from last week, and then we go back to the previous winner, which is Bill. So Aaron and I are always in the driver's seat on this year by not winning to try to box you in. Hawks and Wildcats tomorrow in Evanston.
Yeah, that was almost the exact score that I was thinking about since about Tuesday, But now I gotta switch gears here a little bit because I don't want to get too close, because then you'll be easily able to box us in. Hawks are gonna win.
Ooh.
I'm gonna give you that one. They're gonna win, favored by 2 against, I think, the last that I saw. He messed me up with that score.
You can keep stalling a little bit. Nobody wanted to leave here tonight.
No.
So everybody that's trying to hustle.
Either. It's
hustle.
Not even cold out here, fellas. Come on, I'll play.
And it's the earliest game so far. It's only 10:05 here.
We got a half hour time
still
here.
We got plenty of time.
Yeah.
And people are running out to their cars to listen to this. So Swish pick 21-18, right around the score you wanted. So what are you thinking?
Ooh, I'm going to go 24-21.
24-21 for Bill. In favor of the Hawks, you said, right?
Yep.
So 45. So Swish has 39, and Bill has a total of 45. Aaron, I'm going to put you in charge here because I'm not afraid to just go right. I'm not afraid to have a safety in there just to beat Bill.
But you, sir, are you picking the Hawks then? Is that what you're telling me then?
Well,
because
you're gonna mess this up.
I am. I do it every week. I have to. The Hawks are banged up. It's who knows what kind of condition CJ's in right now.
Can I give you some advice?
Sure.
If you're gonna pick the Wildcats, I guess it doesn't matter. It doesn't. I guess it really doesn't matter, because if you're gonna pick the Wildcats, you're gonna be the only one. So
yep.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I just think the Hawks are banged up. They got a lot of missing pieces, and they're coming into a kind of a lion's den, I think. So I think it's going to be low scoring. I'm going to take Northwestern 16-13.
16-13 Wildcats. That's a 29 score, but you're gonna be alone if the Wildcats win, because I got to do my part here in the Hawks. But who do I want to win?
Yourself.
Do I want
you?
No. Do I want Swish to win or Bill to win? I think I'm going to go right. I'll go right above Bill. I'll give him a couple. I'm going to go Hawkeyes 26, Wildcats 21. That gives me 47 points. So good luck, Bill.
Yeah, well, too bad they're not going to score that many points tomorrow.
Well, if they do.
What was your score, Aaron?
16-13 Northwestern.
16-13 Northwestern.
Low scoring affair.
Yep.
Is
I was sitting down there not paying attention. I was listening to the coach talk about Decorah getting beat.
Yeah, they were. So if Decorah, I'll have to check that out here before we sign off. We'll get
district
it
champs.
It is. Decorah got beat 28-7. So the Hawks are district champs. Good call.
Awesome. Congratulations, Hawks.
There we go. Right. Bill, thanks a lot, buddy boy. We'll talk to you next week up.
All righty. Sounds good.
See you, Bill. That's Bill Logan down on the sideline, and district champs. That sounds good, doesn't it?
It does.
Got a good ring to it. Has
The Hawks still want to go up there and beat Decorah next week, so they just don't have to worry about giving up a district championship to do so. As we've got our predictions, don't forget, next we've got a lot of sports action coming your way next week as West Delaware Volleyball will be on the air at 5 o'clock next Tuesday night, as you can join John Swisher and Joan Salo for the call of that one, as they'll possibly play three games on Tuesday night. Finals from around the area as we do a quick scoreboard check, as West Delaware again here tonight wins 13-9 over Independence. Charles City defeats Decorah 28-7. Waverly Shellrock defeats Crestwood tonight 27-6. It was Solon over Western Dubuque 36-7. Beckman defeats New Hampton tonight 21-13. So the Blazers continue to climb here in Class 2A District Number 3. And last score we had, Anamosa was up 21-0 at halftime over Union. Tipton in the third quarter was leading Monticello 20-17. Lisbon in the fourth quarter, I believe that was, that might have been a final. John Swisher was texting us here tonight as Edco was, after the third quarter, Edco was down 35-0 as East Buchanan defeats North Lynn tonight 56-12, the final score there. As it was, I lost one of the scores tonight. Oh, there it was. It, in the fourth quarter, an updated score. Lisbon leading Edco 42-0 in the fourth quarter. East Buchanan over North Lynn 56-12. And in the third quarter, Mount Vernon was leading Cascade 27-14. Again, thanks to our extra nine sponsors for the Independence Mustangs tonight, along with our 43 regular sports boosters that we have on with us every week. And, of course, Okoboji Grill and Independence on 1749 Golf Course Boulevard in Independence. Okoboji Grill, where good friends meet, our players of the game, one for each team. Nicholas Holt for the Mustangs and Max Ridenour for the Hawks. Again, tomorrow we've got Iowa Hawkeye football starting at 11 o'clock. You can catch the pregame right after the Coach's Corner with Kevin Shookman, which is on at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. You can find out what all the area coaches have to say about tonight's games with Shookie. You're actually going to hear from Shookie here in just a little bit. But that's going to do it for us here. I'd like to thank the sponsors of West Delaware Football on KMCH. Without them and our extra sponsors here tonight as well, this broadcast would not be possible. So we encourage you, whether you're in Manchester or Independence, please continue to shop locally. I'd like to thank Janelle Tucker for running the board for us this evening. Most of all, thank you, the listeners, for Aaron Plain and Bill Logan. This is Jamie Vasky saying good night from Brown Field in Manchester, Iowa. Once again, the final, the West Delaware Hawks 13, the Independence Mustangs 9, and you've been listening to West Delaware Football on Eastern Iowa Sports Station, Mix 94.7 KMCH. Stay tuned for tonight's area online and playback game of the week as Western Dubuque trying to make that push to the playoffs as they travel to take on Solon. And with the call of that game, along with Dan McClain, here's Kevin Shookman.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Solon High School.
Thanks, Janelle. Have a good night.
It's Western Dubuque and Solon. Xavier leads this district at 5-0. Maquoketa at 4-1. Solon.
Coming off of
sails over the quarterback's head, but it ends up about the 2-yard line. So a huge turnover here.
And on the second play of the game, it's kind of how you want to start.
And one of those unusual things that I was kind of nice at was just
Watch the Iowa games with 50 cent wings and drink specials at Hartridge, north of Manchester on 195th Street.
Dunlap Motors and Independence is Chevy Buick, the certified pre-owned Chevy Buick GMC, and nearly 300 new and used cars and trucks in stock. They have big town inventory with small town service. Stop and say hi. That's Dunlap Motors in downtown Independence. Go to DunlapMotorsIndy.com. That's DunlapMotorsIndy.com.
At Precision Collision, we are committed to providing you with high-quality auto body repair and maintenance. Our expertly trained technicians can repair all accidental damage and take you back on the road in no time. Come visit me, Jeff, for a free estimate. We are located along Highway 20 in the Delaware Canal. Precision Collision. One call does it all. Quality repair.
Dreiser Shoes is your specialty shoe store in Dyersville. They carry women's shoes to size 13, men's shoes to size 18. Dreiser Shoes open Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, 9 to 6, Wednesdays, 9:30 until 4, Saturdays, 9 till 4, or by appointment. Good luck from Dreiser Shoes in Dyersville.
When it comes to financial planning, most financial companies focus on your income. At Northwestern Mutual, we focus on your outcome. It takes the right financial partner who cares as much about your future as you do. Building a financial plan to meet your life's priorities and helping you achieve the financial security you're after. Focus on your financial outcome with Northwestern Mutual. Contact me, Mitch Baker, Matt Schulte today. You and Northwestern Mutual stronger together.
American Trust and Savings Bank wishes all area athletes and coaching staff continued success. American Trust and Savings Bank. Locations in Dyersville, Farley, Dubuque, and Des Moines. Simply better banking. Check them out at americantrust.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Wright Funeral Home wishes all area athletes and coaches the best of luck for a successful season. Wright Funeral Home, with locations in Cascade, Dyersville, Epworth, and Farley. Good luck.